Hello and welcome to the Trackmania 2023 Awards. They are finally here and we have a lot of interesting and fun categories and nominees that we are going to present to you today. We have been working a lot on getting this together to make this happen for you guys, for the community. And Trackmania in 2023 was honestly insane. There was so much stuff that has happened in the past year, and we would like to present to you all of this in this award show today. Of course, I am not doing this alone. I am joined by Lucas Turbo and Marius 89, who have worked we have worked together to bring these awards to you.
Yeah, hello guys, welcome to our PowerPoint presentation about the Trackmania Awards. I mean, jokes aside, it just works the best, but I mean, I was hosting the awards in 2021 and 2022. It was a lot of fun, and I did it alongside with Geek, but today I will do it with Lars and Marius. And Marius, I mean, you have put a lot of work into this. I think this would have not been possible without you, because I mean, you just literally wrote down everything right after it happened.
Right, yeah, let's do some backstory to this, to these Trackmania Awards. I was in the jury, same as Torbo, in past years of the, and past editions of the Trackmania Awards. And when you then sit down in December with the other jury members and try to remember all the stuff that happened in the year, it's quite difficult to find it all out. And then I thought in 2023, let's just note it down while it happens, so that we don't have this difficulty. Sadly, the Trackmania Awards didn't happen then at first, because I guess the older hoster didn't have time anymore for it. And yeah, with all the work done, I'm happy that I found another opportunity. And I'm really glad that Lars and Torb would join me with that, and that we can host the Trackmania Awards, because I think the nominees are really great. There's a lot of good stuff in that year.
Yeah, and I think you in particular put a lot of effort into this, so just thank you. I mean, you know, it's like buying presents right after you like notice someone has like a wish or like a special like interest or something. You always do it beforehand, and it makes it so much easier if you just like instantly just write everything down. So without you, this would have definitely not been possible, to say the least.
Yes, looking really forward to it. And I would say then we instantly start, hop into the categories. But first of all, I want to present to you guys the sections that we will be covering in these Trackmania Awards. We have split them up into different sections. And the first one that we will be presenting is going to be the events that have happened this year. Second category right after will be creations, anything from map, video of the year and stuff like that you will be able to find in that category. After that, achievements, great category, looking forward to this one quite a bit. There has been so many great things that the players in Trackmania have achieved this year, and we want to really highlight that. Then afterwards, we have all the great storylines that happened this year. Fifth category is going to be really fun, I think. It is moments. I think that is one of the most fun categories. I think you can be looking forward to that. There's so many funny, interesting, crazy moments that happened this year. And then the final category, we are going to focus on the people, everybody from player of the year, most improved player, stuff like that will be featured in the very last category. And without further ado, I would say then, let's hop straight in into events.
Yes, okay. So we have the first category in events, which is offline event of the year. And the first one, oops, we've already seen it, but I think, I mean, it's a no-brainer to put this one in. Ascension, I mean, the biggest prize pool that has happened in Trackmania, 128,000 euro. I mean, also, like, very good that... we had a deal, I think it was with Diablo 4 or something like that, that he got something off of it. But then Zerator got so many subs, and with every sub, he put 2 euro into the prize pool. So there were over 60,000 subs. And I mean, at the end, it was 69,000 euro for first position. So that is our first nominee in this category.
Yeah, here you can also see one more time the after movie of the Ascension Cup. It was absolutely crazy, really great production quality especially.
Yeah. I think an unforgettable event, so make sure to watch that. And I mean, this will not be, and I think this will not shock anybody, this will not be the first time, and also not the last time that we're gonna see Ascension on here. Or not the last time, so because... It has been a blast.
Oh my god.
All right. Okay, there you go. And
well.
We have already okay. Event number two is Comic-Con Baltics. I mean, I've attended this event. I think it was a very, very familiar experience with everybody there. We had 8 invited players and 8 players who have qualified in an online qualifier, and then the offline finals took place at the Comic-Con Baltics in Vilnius. And it was just a great organization, and the level was also insane.
Yeah, and here we can also see the final round where you could see Elcon really dominating in the grand final and then taking it home as well. It was played in reverse cup mode as well, which was quite interesting. And yeah, Elcon taking it home.
Yeah, it was really cool. Also the venue there, and just having only 16 players in there also made it like you could talk to everybody. We went out for dinner. It was really cool. So probably one of my favorite events that I attended last year. And let's come to the third event, which is the F-Ride Trackmania LAN. 2,000 euro of prize pool, and it was played in a duo cup mode format, and we had so many close matches in there. I mean, maybe you can think about the Aurel finish. That was just a great snipe, and it was just a great event.
Bran is gonna be the leader.
It was a very notorious
so
clip.
And it's unfortunately gone for Big Chen. Let's start to pull something together. It's a great time. No! Chen Aurel to win! Aurel! Aurel! It's done for BDS!
I love this clip so much. It's the, yeah. It's the greatest thing ever. It's so exciting stuff. And that round there decided the cup. That's incredible.
And I mean, Giga and me were casting it. And I mean, and the thing is, like, we were so invested into this whole competition because it was just so good. So that's why the reaction was so pure, right? So that's why this happened. Okay, I mean, we've already seen the fourth nominee. It is Racer Summit, probably the tournament with the best trophy that has happened. I mean, we had great level. We had Stufs and Epos being absolutely on point when it comes to their performance. I mean, Epos then eventually took it home. And also the venue and the trophy. It was so nice to go there. And I mean, just watch yourself what happened at the winning moment where Epos absolutely dominated this match against Panda, Stufs, and Massa.
Massa
with a mistake. Here in the end.
Epos in great fashion. Yeah.
Epos didn't even realize it at first. Between the players, just and we have our champion.
Epos winning the incredible. Taking it home.
But yeah, it was such a nice venue, and yeah, very good. So Epos with like put himself on the board there on this one. And I mean, then also attended this event, which is our penultimate nominee, the World Championship. 16 orcs with 2 players each qualified for the World Championship, which marked the end of the Trackmania World Tour of 2023. And it was so, like, we had so many good matches. It just kept on giving and giving, and with a price of 25,000, it was just very nice. So if you have not seen some of the matches, I think there's like 10 good matches of this World Championship. It feels like also with including the qualifiers and the wildcard events. Make sure to watch that.
Yeah, and the entire TMGL beforehand across the entire year building up to this moment, which was then played on stage as well in France. Really, really exciting stuff and incredible level by the players as well.
Yeah, also insane production there. I mean, also attending this event as an official caster was a lot of fun, and then just seeing this like far-fetched level from players is just incredible. And offline event of the year, last nominee is XP Evo, also probably a no-brainer. This land in Cologne, I mean, it was super chaotic. So many people have attended it, and just so many people were also interested in it. 5,500 euro prize pool, and I mean, Otak in the end took it home. It was just such a nice event, and I'm looking forward to the events this year because it already got announced that XP Evo 2.0 will happen.
Yeah, it was so much fun. So many people you could meet there. It was really kind of like a Trackmania community event in that way as well.
It was really cool. So hopefully I will see you guys there, or we will see you guys there at XP Evo, because we will be there.
But that was the offline event of the year category. We have Ascension, Ifray, Trackmania LAN, World Championship, Comic-Con Baltic, Racer Summit, and also XP Evo. But with that, I would say we then move on to the next category, which will be online event of the year.
Exactly, online event of the year now. And yeah, let's start off with the first one, which is the 24-hour race. And yeah, this is a competition that we have every single year once. Often it struggles sometimes here and there during the 24 hours with some technical difficulties, but this edition here was extremely smooth. The map was extremely good and we had an incredible match, incredible fight for the first place. There's actually nothing bad about this cup. This was very good last year.
It also went very smooth this time. Yeah. It was really fun.
Also, we had so many players participating as well in a 24-hour race. It was really great to see.
All right, for the second nominee, we will showcase one of the weekly cups that happens every Thursday to Friday night at 4 a.m. for Europeans. This is the Alamo Cup.
Americans type 1.
Yeah, exactly. So this is a competition, especially for the North Americans, but it has grown massively during this year. And nowadays it has partly over 80 players, and that deep in the night for Europeans. But also a lot of Europeans are still attending this cup.
Yeah.
And some of the maps used there also got track of
players. Yeah, we can also see here that it has 80 players weekly, and that at 4 a.m. Is really, really impressive.
All right. For the next nominee, we go to the Chase Cup, hosted by Spam. This was early in the year, around April, I think. And had a prize pool of $1,000. You see here a clip that is a very close round here in the end. What the teams in chase mode want to achieve is that always the last player of the team has to be the first one to cross the next checkpoint. And with that, the team gets a point. And you have to do these switches between the players as fast as possible. And two teams drive it against each other. And you just want to beat the other team with that.
Yeah, this is the only mode in Trackmania that really does team play like this. You actually have to work with your teammates, communicate, and it's really cool in that way. And you can also see the snipe coming in by Maris just at the end.
Yeah, that was great.
Overtaking. Great stuff.
I mean, then also Chase being used at Twitch Rivals as well at the end of 2023. So that was also a lot of fun. In general, very, very good modes. It's just so much fun to play.
So the fourth nominee for online event of the year will be the Lacoste event. So Lacoste had four maps in total and a big hunting competition with over 3,000 euros prize money that Shadow Crancer has won. It started off with a track of the day where then a lot of players saw then a full speed map that they could drive and hunt, but the other three maps were then very long and very good as well, and the hunting was done by a lot of the best players in Trackmania.
Yeah, it was especially incredible. The idea was to beat a 12 minute 12 seconds time, which was actually quite difficult, but in the end I think like 80-90 different players actually achieved that, and you really needed a strong time to be able to be even in the top 50. So this is an event that really motivated a lot of players to hunt and give these maps a shot, and I think this is of course a sponsor event, but this really shows how to do a sponsor event right. Like, this was amazing quality and everything. So really cool stuff and well implemented into Trackmania.
All right, let's go to the next nominee, and this is the Marchi Monday. Marchi hosted this cup twice in the year, and the prize pool, which just came from her donations from her community, became by that point, like in the first edition, one of the biggest Trackmania prize pools we ever had, with 15,300 euros in the first edition and 14,000 US dollars in the second edition of the Marchi Monday.
Yeah, it's such a nice event. I mean, the only non-fun thing is to qualify for it. This can sometimes be a bit frustrating, but other than that, it's really good.
Here we can also see one time Margie herself explaining the final format.
The current season is also ongoing.
Three round per map.
Yeah.
The person with the lowest
tomorrow there's another qualifier.
Gets knocked out. But for the final, it's five rounds. This is the info. So
Granati type one.
Wow. Yeah, it's just incredible. Like, insane how much this competition grew and how much effort was put into it as well. And yeah, it was I think 30 players in the finals competing against each other. Really good level and very exciting stuff.
So, and the last nominee in online event of the year is the United Masters. So this is now a competition from Trackmania United Forever, which is actually not dead. Actually the opposite, because Trackmania United Forever never had really cups with prize money, but this was hosted twice in the year and both editions had 2,000 euros or more prize pool. And with that, also the best players then attended there in endurance races, and you could then sum up points over the whole season.
Yep, and that was then online event of the year. We have 24-hour race, a Lamo Cup, a Chase Cup, a Lacoste, Magi Monday, and United Masters. Also, for everybody who is just joining now, later into the stream, one more time, we are going to be presenting the categories and the nominees now. Right after the this show is completed, you guys will be able... or will be given the form and you will be able to vote as well, but only after we have gone through all the nominees, where you then also know everybody that has been nominated. All right, going to the next section, and it will be creative project of the year, and the first one that we have is going to be the 1000 AT battle. You might have seen it on this channel as well. Was really one of the content ideas, especially that captivated on a lot of people on Twitch and YouTube alike. It was basically just the challenge to get to 1000 author medals as quickly as possible. Scrappy versus myself, and it was definitely one of the most hype things that happened in the previous year. Next one that we have on the list is, I believe, Editor Plus Plus. I honestly almost would have liked to just give Xertrov alone a category. Editor Plus Plus is the biggest thing that he has worked on, though. Xertrov is a plugin maker with Open Planet, or in Open Planet, and the stuff that he has done is just incredible. If you don't know what Editor Plus Plus can do, well, basically, think of something you could do in the editor. Editor Plus Plus can do it. Moving blocks, possible because of Editor Plus Plus. Custom bumpers, boosters, like the NAR bumper, for example, all done through Editor Plus Plus. You have so many possible things that you can do, so many quality of life changes. It is honestly the best thing ever, and it's not not even the only thing that Xertrov has worked on. Incredible stuff that he has done for the community, and want to give a huge shout out for that as well. Next thing that we have on the list, the next creative project, is the Elimination Race, hosted by Edge and his community, and I think if we watch the first video, he sums
Welcome
it up the best.
Trackmania Elimination Race, where 130 regions of the world compete together on one track.
I love that
the
series.
The slowest car gets eliminated on each round, and so by good. The time I finish this sentence, Japan already crosses the finish line in first place. GG. The map is very chaotic, cars are crashing and flying all around the place, and it's hard to say who's going to be the unlucky one finishing as last. There will be 112 rounds, each one on a different map, and on each one of them, one country that finishes last will be eliminated. Here, by the way, you have the complete list of all participants. Pick your favorite, and we are getting back to our track. The finish zone is getting flooded with cars, but there are still a lot of players on the battlefield. We are having Iraq among the last remaining cars, but luckily it reached the finish line just now. And sadly, the last car to get to the finish is Guatemala. GG, sadly it takes the last spot in the giant Trackmania elimination race. See you.
It is honestly insane. So this is just one basically short series that Edge did. And you see all of the participants here. He says 112 rounds. He wasn't joking. They actually kept this through. The entire playlist is also going to be linked in the Google form. 112 rounds they have made on different tracks like this. 112. Incredible commitment there. Actually insane what they have worked on here. 112 separate rounds that you can all see where then always one country gets eliminated. But the next category or the next nominee that we will have is the escape room tournament that we had or that we played, I believe, around November. Four different duo teams were invited to a special escape room, and was a really fun and creative project that was done. There was, I believe, Twilux and Röder, I think Wingo Bear and Yannex. Well, I hope I'm not saying this wrong, because I didn't double check. Scrappy and myself, and also Virtual and Janik, who all competed in the tournament to see who could finish the escape room the fastest. There was a lot of stuff done with the server and the map working together. You really had to work as a team to be able to solve this one, and it was a really fun event. Next one we have, though, is Falling Turtles. Falling Turtles was basically the deep dip equivalent that we had in 2023, hosted by Kiraj and Zix, as far as I'm aware. And they did an incredible stuff, bringing the only up RPG vibe together for a track that is even still being hunted today at the moment. It was a really fun competition to see who could finish this track the fastest. Tournament as well. Alright, and then the next one after that we have Pathfinding Cup. The Pathfinding Cup, and this is the trailer that Tom has done. And here you can see definitely what encompasses this tournament the best.
We should protect him. We should protect him. He's a great mapper.
Oh, dude, I fucking hate you, Tom. You're such a piece of shit, dude.
I just love this trailer. Garbage, man.
Yeah, was, thank you very much. That was mine here.
Pathfinding Cup is basically pathfinding maps driven on a server with Ghost Force on, and everybody competing to finish as quickly as possible. And great fun. A lot of people have played it in the last year. Great competition. And that was our sixth nominee for Creative Project of the Year. The seventh nominee, we are not done yet, there have been so many creative projects this year, is Puzzle Together, brought to us by Yannex, and the trailer for this one also just speaks for itself. Incredible stuff, so much fun to play, completely new game mode basically, similar to the escape room where you have to work together with a teammate. But the special thing here is you have to work together with different cars as well. You can see.
Wild Granadi appears.
Basically, you have to use the different characteristics of the two cars that were released at that time to be able to solve these different rooms. And as you can see here, for example, with Noster, you can steer together, drive together and stuff like that. It's a great stuff that you can do with it, especially with collisions. Did you think 7 was a lot? We have an 8th one as well, and it is Random Map Together. Random Map Together was also released last year, This is a very difficult category, I will say. I don't envy you guys having to vote for this. Random Map Together also was released last year. Here we have a good example clip of how it would look like. You would play on a server with a lot of players together, and once one player gets the author medal, the server skips to the next track. Basically just playing Random Map Challenge, get as many authored medals on random maps as possible. On a server together with lots of people, really fun. Has also been quite hunted as well to get the best run with this format. Yeah, a lot of fun always.
Yeah, 8 nominees in this category. I mean, maybe we can just see them all here. Yeah, as,
there's one missing. I don't know where it went, but that is fine.
Yeah, there's one missing. Oops. The 1000 AT battle. Editor++, Elimination Race, Escape Room, Falling Turtles, Pathfinding Cup, Puzzle Together, and Random Map Together will be correct.
The 1080 is missing.
Yes, yeah, but that's of course not missing in the Google form, where you will be eventually able to vote. But let's go then to the next category, or the next section even, which is going to be Creations. And the first one we have is Map of the Year.
Oh, I mean, this one has been a very, very, like, I would say hard category to do. So it was very, very hard to just put names out there and just be able to, like, just rate a map, I would say, like this. But our first nominee, and I think it's a map that you've all seen a lot, also on this channel here, it is Cascades by Tom. I mean, this has been such an insane map. I mean, 150 checkpoints. A long map, and I mean, already the first finish was not that easy. I mean, I play tested this map, and I think it took me like 8 to 9 hours. The last 10 checkpoints were even harder beforehand.
And this map also showed the moving blocks for the first time, I think, it was used in that way.
Yeah, really creative stuff that was used on this map. Got lots of awards, lots of people introduced to RPG with this one, 150 checkpoints. There was also a tournament hosted for this one as well. Definitely a great track and great world record battles on it as well. But then the next category that we have is...
Concrete. It is Concrete by BMX22C. I mean, this map has been a reworked map from Trackmania 2 Stadium, and it also came out with an event which was a hunting competition with more than 800 euro. I mean, it was just an insane map to play. And of course, before we just jump into the next map, we should mention that we don't include Track of the Days here, and also we got a lot of help here from Agrabu and the Raypoint mappers to help us with the nominations.
Yes, indeed. Great map here as well. Really nice atmosphere. The map was originally created by Nubizor in Trackmania 2, but then reworked by BMX to fit into TM 2020, where then also an event was hosted as well.
All right. I mean, it's just a very nice and smooth map, and was very good to playing this one. The next nomination is a map that is not that easy to play, but let's just see the trailer. It is Don't Fear by Ski Freak.
In a world deep in fear, about 10 mappers come together to create a new path forward. After 2.5 years of building, we have achieved the pinnacle of Trackmania mapping, a single map file that takes about 40 minutes to open in the editor. Thus,
I love Ski Freak.
Yeah, it's so nice. But for me, my favorite map from last year is Mindor by Yannix. I mean, this one has also been such a great map. I mean, Yannix, I think, put 250 hours into this map. And then I think there was even the update coming up after this, breaking the map. And then Yannix just was staying up all night, fixing the wood and all of this. But Mindor is the most awarded map on TMX. And it just... such a great thing to play. It's so much fun, it's so engaging, and scenery is so unique.
Yeah, he has worked so much on this. Great trailer as well. Yeah, this one is probably the biggest no-brainer to include for Map of the Year. Incredible stuff, and really it deserves to be showcased as well. And then the final map that we have for Map of the Year is going to be...
is something different. It is Void by Yuvo, and I think for this one it's also very important to just watch the video that has been created there as well and upload on Spams channel, so you can see it how he played through this map.
Here you see, first of all, the GPS by Juvo showcasing how to drive the track. It's a very unique track. Yes. Completely different to how most mappers approach mapping in the game.
Yeah, but guys, again, this category was very hard to just pinpoint down five maps. We all know that there's like, probably, it's so biased, so, you know, there has been so many great creations, and I think this year will be even better, or like, at least, like that, right? Because there have been so many good releases already happening.
Kind of like a skip to 1955. Oh, okay.
Sure.
Where's the GPS? 19 minutes 55.
Yeah. Sure. There you go.
Actually, there was a hidden path in this map as well that Spam actually was able to find now with Chem 7 at this part of the video. And you could explore a completely new area.
Guys, I found something.
Yeah, and the unique thing with this is that the blocks only, you can only see the blocks if you go close enough. So that's a real challenge to actually find this, that's for sure. As you can see. But if you want to find out more about this or look, try it out, it's best to try it out yourself. You will be able to find all the map files and also these videos in the Google form as well after the watcher. Here, once again, you have... the nominees, it's going to be Cascades, Mindor, Concrete, Void, and Don't Fear for Map of the Year. But that is not the only map category that we have. We also have the beautifully named Track of the Day of the Year.
Exactly. So... now you also know why we didn't include any Track of the Days in the previous category, because those nominees have their own category. We have, of course, a lot of great maps. I mean... 365. And yeah, we start off with the map Eros to Distress by Prof, which is a speed tech map, got also highly awarded on MX. And here you can see the run.
It was a lot of fun to playing this map. Very nice speed tech map. And of course, Dexter, yours truthful, has the world record. I had the world record on this one, probably still has, but that's the.
And yes, it was definitely a great map here. Lots of fun to play in Cover Day. It was a great battle. I remember lots of people driving really fast times, and also just in general, super fun speed tech map. And the scenery is just incredible on this one. As we have come accustomed to with Prof scenery, it's just really, really nice stuff that he is able to create with scenery in this game. And there you go, coming around the last turns, and that is the map right there, Eros to Distress by Prof.
The next nominee is gonna be God Valley, and you might remember it. It's built by Intex, and it has three routes, and they were meant to be equally fast. They were also very equally fast. It was quite interesting, because in the Cup of the Day, I think the plastic route won. But then in other in the V1s, other rounds won. So it was actually, people were going different ways. The plastic round in the Cup of the Day, for example, the winner, don't remember now who it was, he was the only one taking that line with the plastic, while everyone else just went on the grass, which was the easier way. But apparently you could also be super fast on the grass, as Zodiac showed off in his world record.
Yeah, really well-built map with the unique concept here as well by Intex.
So the third nominee here is Observer. Ah yeah, this track is built by Saphiron, and yeah, let's just watch the video. It was having a lot of reactor boost driving on walls and roof ceilings, mainly on plastic surface, a lot of black and white as well with a theme here. And yeah, was a very good map as well.
Yeah, incredible verticality used in this track, which is quite unique. You don't often see this kind of stuff being built, and just incredible scenery once again on this one. It was also still drivable and fun in Cover of the Day as well, which is honestly quite impressive looking at the layout of the track. And here we see coming down, back down into the stadium, and then finishing in the building right here. There you go. That was Observer by Zafiron. Next one is going to be...
So, yeah, we also wanted to include one of the LOL track of the days from the first day of a month. And the decision went to Planet Magnet by Moisty 3000. Yeah, just the thumbnail of this map already reminds you which track that is. You basically drive around the globe on Magnet. It is a little blind, like you have to learn the turns definitely.
And they also behave different, like depending if you like upside down or you go
up or you go left, right. Or downhill.
Yeah. It was really hard. I think I was in div 7 here or div 8. I could not figure it out. Really.
Yeah,
it was
but so such a unique idea though that done here. You can see maybe also the video zooming out slowly and being able to see the entire track here. It's a complete globe that was being used there as the track.
Yeah. Reminded me of Super Mario Galaxy. Maybe some of you.
We also have a nominee for the Royal community with our next map, which is Stars of Glory by Maverick and Clover. Yeah, this track of the day featured basically a white, green, blue, red, and black section. And yeah, very difficult to drive, of course. Some tubes here, some quarter pipe jumps coming up. I think there was also something backslide-like in the end. We're gonna see in the video. Definitely very nicely built. And yeah, this made for track of the day.
Yeah, it was the map to introduce the Royal Nations Cup, as you can see right there on the logo. The Royal Nations Cup was an event hosted by the Royal community where all the different nations fought against each other on the racetrack. And was introduced by this lovely track of the day. Really fun, interesting to see such a concept in being implemented in track of the day. And it was a really fun cover day, I remember.
I think you got second there or some or third, right? Or
yeah, I was. I was like ITB top three, I think actually,
such a good map to hunt. It was so much fun. Like I remember, I traveled to Norway next day, and I literally played this map at Arizal's place for 4 hours. It was so nice to play, really. But one of my all time favorite track of the day is definitely top five.
If I tell you the name of the last one, of the last nominee, I think everyone immediately knows which track that is. Yeah, Tokyo Drift by Otla Rukixus. Yeah, it used the new wood physics with wet tires, so wet wood, but in very low speed. And you had a feeling like in the movies here, in the third part when they were in Japan, in Tokyo.
Yeah, also accompanied by the great song, usually even on the in-game as well, was really fun. You really felt like you were actually in one of these drifting events. It's a nice atmosphere, really gives off the vibes, and also super fun to play. It's very interesting. There you go, that is Tokyo Drift by Oklavuxkus. I surely pronounced it correctly. And here we have, once again, the nominees for Track of the Day of the Year. We have Eros 2, Distress, God Valley, Observer, Planet Magnet, Stars of Glory, and Tokyo Drift. All right. And now the last category featuring or talking about mapping is going to be Mapper of the Year. And first of all, the first mapper that we want to showcase is Ellipse, and that is mostly not just for his mapping, but in particular for his scenery that he is able to create on his tracks. Very unique stuff that he is able to create on his tracks. He also built a lot of tracks, I think over 30 tracks or something he uploaded in 2023. You will be able to find all of those, of course, in the Google form, as we said. But yeah, that's the first one, Ellipse. Next one is going to be Intax. We saw him just earlier. He built God Valley, one of the maps featured in Track of the Day of the Year, but that is not the only map that he built, of course. So many great maps, especially one of the mappers that I think improved the most throughout the last year. Next one, we also saw him earlier as well, is Prof, very unique speed tech style, got a lot of track of the days in the last year, great stuff that he was able to create, and yeah, just incredible what he was able to accomplish with his scenery as well, especially.
Exactly.
Mm. Also, one important thing is that we want to feature a lot of variety in the nominees for mapping, not just have like five or something tech builders or something like that. But because of that, we also have as next entry Kiraj as an RPG mapper. He has built so many top quality RPGs in the last year. As we saw earlier, of course, also Falling Turtles he worked on. He worked on other tracks as well, like Quandary Islands and so many other things that he has worked on the RPG community. In general, basically carrying the RPG, like the original Trackmania 2 kind of style RPG category on his back. And then the next one, well, we mentioned him earlier as well, is going to be a Tom. While he has only built two official maps on TMX, which are Cascades and a World of Tompus, they are, of course, of very high quality. We have Cascades earlier mentioned for Map of the Year and World of Tompus. You have probably seen it recently as well, his his vision of a World of Vampus style map. It's very fun and very well made. And also, of course, not just that, but also hosted the Pathfinding Cup, which included like 15 or more maps that he built, all in the Pathfinding style, all like 10 minutes long. Incredible stuff what he was able to accomplish last year. And then another different type of entry here is going to be a Ville. As the last entry for Mapper of the Year, he has been working especially on his stream a lot, on his mapping, has been showcasing mapping very prominently. One big thing that Ville worked on last year is the Spring 2023 campaign that he worked on. 25 maps that he built after the core player base kind of got fed up of the Spring 2023 campaign because it was for most advanced players too easy. So Ville came in and just built 25 tracks for a completely new campaign. It was a lot of fun, and also is still actively working on a massive massive track project as well, which is Core. He has worked on that track for over 500 hours, and yeah, has been working very strongly on this one. There are, of course, so many mappers that we could mention here, but we want to just fixate on a few given styles. Of course, if people are not mentioned here, that does not mean that they're not good mappers. We thought about a lot of them, but these were the ones that... definitely stuck out the most in their respective categories.
Yeah, it's maybe also worth possible, mentioning yeah. that on Mania Exchange, the User Choice Awards happened, and they go, because it's Mania Exchange, they go much deeper into mapping categories, also for every specific style. They had votes for the best map and the best mapper, so they will also find many more names, but that would have been too much for our Trackmania Awards here.
Indeed. Yeah, I mean,
too detailed.
You could just list 30, 40, 50 mappers, but we try to include someone from every sort of category and also put some new names out there. And I mean, it's just almost impossible to.
Yeah, but I think we did a good job. I'm quite happy with the nominees that we came up with. And now we go into the next category. I think one of the hardest categories this year, and it's going to be Video of the Year.
Yeah, I mean, we've all consumed a lot of Trackmania content, whether it's on Twitch or on YouTube, but there has been a lot of great videos that have been released over this time span, and we decided on five nominees in this category, but it was indeed very hard. But the first one is 3 years of Trackmania by Isirix. It was a very nice video that just rewinded the competitive aspect, but also what kind of happened in the community and, you know, the new console release, how the console update was just handled the esport aspects of the game since its release, and it's a very good video. It gives me a lot of good and bad chills, but well, I mean, just watch it yourself. It gives me goosebumps every time when I watch it.
Yeah, all of the links, these videos are of course very long, so we cannot show them here, but all of the links are of course included in the form where you can then vote after the watch show, of course.
Yeah, so then the second nominee is the last video. I mean, maybe there will be another one, maybe some sort of fun facts of the Trackmania Iceberg series. Trackmania Iceberg Part 3, a series that I just really enjoyed watching and also reacting to on stream. A nice project from Lufok and his friends, where there's also great storytelling in and just digs deep into the iceberg of Trackmania. For the people who do not know what an iceberg is, it's like listing obscure facts about the game that are lesser known and known. For example, something like you have to pay coppers in order to drive officially in Trackmania United, or stuff like that. And it gets more obscure. And this is the third and the last layers of this series. And this was just a great video to watch.
Yes, indeed. It's a long project that they also worked on. They started with the part one, I believe, in November 2022, and then finally finished the final section of the iceberg here, part three, I think, in summer of 2023. And yeah, I think this is definitely one that got a lot of people together and showcased a lot of unique aspects of Trackmania that quite a lot of people probably were not aware of until this video came out.
Yeah. My favorite one was the Christina story. If you're aware, you're aware. But yeah, the middle nomination is the Deep Fear world record story by Virtual. I mean, Virtual storytelling has been on point also in 2023. And I mean, this is just immortalizing the run from Muda on the hardest full speed track in Trackmania Nations forever. This map is just so difficult, and it just added with great storytelling and just showing how a perfect speedrun looks like. So very nice storytelling, and I mean, an even insaner world record from Muda. All right, the penultimate nominee is also a series that I really liked in the past, and just videos that are so good to watch because they go so in depth as well, and they just explain a very advanced thing with ease. It is Trackmania, an unbeatable AI by Yosh. Would be a bit of a surprise if you don't include him here. I mean, Yosh trained an AI in Trackmania with reinforcement learning until he couldn't beat it. And this video got 11 million views on YouTube. That is quite something.
Yeah, incredible video. It's so fun to watch the animations, especially seeing how the AI progresses, as you can see in the video. And definitely also a video that has found a very wide audience, and definitely deservedly so. I think that is a great video to showcase to a lot of people. And yeah, great stuff by Yosh and what he has been doing on YouTube.
Yeah, definitely. And there's one more nominee, and also just a new range that has kind of opened last year as well due to Beta, who has been doing a lot of great videos about that. The greatest Kaki player. I mean, you often think it's Carl Jr. or Hefest who's the greatest of all time in Trackmania, but no, it is someone else. I mean, this video was just showing the development of Simo 900 as a mapper and also as a player, and it has been so fun to watch it, just accomplishing something that no one has done before, and Beta with insane storytelling as well. Definitely worth to mention on this list as well. So five nominees, five different people. There you can see them again. 3 years of Trackmania, Trackmania Iceberg Part 3, Deep Fear World Record Story, Training an Unbeatable AI, and The Greatest Kaki Player. If you have not seen all of those videos, we can just recommend them to you. They're awesome, and they're also linked in the Google Sheet that we're gonna reveal after the award show.
Yeah, if you have not watched them, then definitely give them a shot. You will not be disappointed, I can tell you that for sure. And what a difficult category this is to vote on. But I would say we move on to the final category of the creation section, which will be Movie of the Year.
Yeah, all right. Our first nominee and Movie of the Year, they are sorted now by when they got uploaded, by the way. The first one is the Trackmania World Tour Playoffs trailer. Yeah, the videos can be watched. Some of them that we mentioned here are also a bit longer, so the videos can also be watched in the Google form. But also by the picture, you might remember the trailer already.
Yeah, it was a great trailer for the world tour showing off. Basically, the difference between movies and videos in this case is that movies are more cinematic and videos are usually more about storytelling. That's how we differentiated them. Movies more feature on just gameplay and showcasing that also through the media tracker cameras and stuff like that, the more aesthetic aspect of movie making in Trackmania.
Right, the second nominee is also a trailer, and it's the one from XP Evo.
Yeah, this one went hard.
Yeah, made by MCYC, a lot of 3D animation for this one, as you can see in the thumbnail here as well. Really cool stuff that he was able to create, very cinematic, and got definitely hyped for XP Evo.
The third nominee is gonna be an after movie from Team Big at Ascension. If you haven't seen this video yet, I definitely tell you to watch it. It's very good. Big, the team, was of course part of Ascension with their players Kanadi and Massa, and also with Trilux as a caster. And their production team has created this after movie, which shows the tension and the incredible atmosphere and some camera angles and interviews as well that from behind the scenes that you not haven't seen yet. It's only 5 minutes long. So it's not a super long video, but it covers basically everything and gives a very good atmosphere.
Yeah, it shows an unforgettable day from Ganadi and Massa, I think. It's great.
It really goes hard, this video, that's for sure.
All right, the fourth one is then again a trailer, and now from the World Championship.
Yeah, similar to the World Tour Playoffs trailer, this one also was honestly incredibly made. Got you really hyped for the World Championship that happened in the last year. If you haven't seen it, definitely take a look. It is really well made. And the last nominee that we have for Movie of the Year,
yeah, is Cybertas: Man vs. Machine by Igentool. Yeah, he showcases incredible TAS records in his videos. It's like also a series, but this was uploaded in 2023. A lot of TAS records on khaki maps from different khaki seasons, and very high quality, these TAS records, and also a very high quality in the video making.
Yeah, he really showcased a lot of the aesthetics, as you can see in the thumbnail as well. This synth-based, however you call it, aesthetic was really nice and implemented in this video, and was a really good video and very high production quality for sure on this one. That is Movie of the Year. World to Playoffs trailer, XP Evo trailer, World Championship trailer. At first, we were actually thinking about calling a trailer of the year, but then we also included Cybertas and also the big Ascension after movie.
I think it's a bit cropped actually on the other side, because people cannot see the whole, they see trailee and machine, so the E is missing, so maybe you wanna...
Thank you for telling me. Yes, that is true. Yeah. Well, okay,
so
thank
was,
you.
Yeah, so now
only 1 hour into the award show, that's no problem. Yeah, honestly, I mean, on most shows it didn't crop too much on most scenes. Oops.
Well, I mean, then let's jump into our next category here, actually, which is also a new sort of segment. It is achievements, and with that one we're gonna start with Task of the Year.
Yeah, I'm very excited about this one. This is a new category that we will be featuring this year in the Trackmania Awards. And honestly, even though it is a new category, I think this is one of the craziest and most difficult categories to vote for. I would have no idea what to vote for. These are all amazing. And let's start off, firstly, with AO1 in TMNF. Absolutely pushed to the limit right here. AO1 down to a 23.66 tool assisted speedrun. Of course, if you don't know what a tool assisted speedrun is, this is basically a thing that is now possible in Trackmania Nations Forever and the older games as well, where you can basically record goals and runs input for input to try to get them as perfect as possible. And yeah, this one just incredible, down to the absolute perfection on AO1 TMNF.
Need to maybe mention that this is now the world record Lion TAS. There are also TASs on this track that already use the extra bugs.
Yeah, the nose boosting and stuff, but yeah, this is the world record approach without any nose boosting, as you can see here, going to a 0.66. Next one that we will have, a very unique one as well, very hyped when it came out, it is AO7, also in Trackmania Nations Forever. They were able to come up with a new cut route on AO7, only possible through TAS, and it is incredible how this one came together, and especially really funny how they were all trying to improve it for so long, eventually ended up at a 23.8, and then suddenly it jumped to a 22.5, and just look at this nose bug turnaround, jump back into the finish. It's incredible how this even works out, that there was exactly a window right there. Incredible stuff. And yeah, AO7, TMNF, TAS, definitely up there. Yeah, good luck anybody trying this one.
Big parts of the TAS community worked on this to make this cut possible. It is really difficult.
Yeah.
The world record line, surely. I think surely. This is one of the cuts that will never be done.
Yeah, I definitely think so as well, unless there's a new discovery. But yeah. I definitely don't think that part is possible. Next one we have, a bit different this time. It is going to be a Deep Fear TAS that came out this year. It is, I believe, was done by Andy, if I remember correctly, and yeah, it is minus 32 seconds on the real-time world record set by Mudder, and also 16 seconds faster than the previous world record. And you, if you look at these lines, it is just incredible what they were able to accomplish here. I think this was 3 months of work on this track. Of course, a 10-minute track, perfectly tasked with speed slides and different lines, getting less airtime everywhere, and doing so many tricks, runtime bugs as well, and so much stuff here, which elevated this one definitely up there to be one of the contenders for a task of the year.
Basically, if you get perfect speed slides with a TAS, you're getting too fast for this map. But they found ways to always get like a nose down to minimize the airtime, like with Rammstein bugs or with flow tricks, to basically keep the momentum up over the whole run. Really crazy.
Okay, the next category that we or the next nominee that we have is a Puzzle D2 done by Kimura. And this one is so interesting because with a puzzle, you can build the track first before you actually play it. And here you can really see what you can then accomplish if you combine that with a tasking and a Uber bugs. Don't blink. I'll just tell you, do not blink on this one. Author time is a 58. This will drive a little bit faster. Here we go.
Just a little bit. That's... I mean, who has played this map knows how maybe the intention away looks like. Definitely not like this.
This is just insane. 20 seconds. This run was also 10 seconds faster than the previous TAS. I'm gonna show it from here again, because literally you cannot blink on this one. It is absolutely insane what Kiyuma was able to do here, of course, combining puzzle mode where you can build the track and tasking as well. Yeah, it's just absolutely crazy how fast you can go through a track like this. As a work of art.
Gives almost unlimited opportunities of what you can do, and he came up with this one. Just crazy, like insane TAS.
Yeah, the next one afterwards, a completely different style again. It is a satisfaction by a Glitched, where he built a track to show off specific tasks or tricks that you can do in insane what he was able to accomplish here. The video is 12 minutes long, 13 minutes long. The map is 12 minutes long, and just watch what he built here. The entire track is built for this task right here. Just a small bug site there, then clip there into now nose bug combination through the poles. Just absolutely beautiful. Jump across here, small Uber bug, jump through the ring, jump down here, then bounce on the wall in the back onto a pipe, and just insane all the way through this entire video. I have watched this video from start to finish maybe a few too many times already. It's just so satisfying and almost hypnotizing when watching it. And yeah, just look at this. This goes on for 13 minutes. Absolute insanity of a task. 13 minutes. We of course cannot show everything, but it's just incredible, this one here. And the last one that we have in the task section is a different game this time. It is a Valley C15, also done by Kimura. And with Valley, of course, Trackmania 2 Valley, there is a specific technique that is possible to gain more speed. And you will see it shortly right here. This is a multi-lap track, three laps. And this task is able to shave off 35 seconds on the world record route. And you can see right here, starting, you go backwards in Trackmania 2 Valley. If you have not seen it before, you have higher acceleration backwards, especially when you are steering. You want to steer as much as possible. You get so fast that you have to do intentional warbanks here to slow down, to not be too fast here. And then also here, you would be too fast normally, so he just jumps across the track, slows down with that as well to get through this section that's not done yet, lands down here, and now watch this. 360 flip in, spin into there at the end of the lap, and now this goes on for three laps right here. Coming into lap number three, there he's so fast. He already minus 21 seconds at this point on the original world record. You can see here as well, now a lot faster in these sections because of the extra speed coming from the previous lap. And tasking this, of course, you cannot just copy and paste it from lap 1 to lap 2 to lap 3. Every single lap had to be tasked individually, and it's just beautiful what Kimura was able to come up here, and if just really course, unique.
If you try to drive backwards with Valley car, you will realize how precise that is. You easily slide out.
Yeah, you can see the inputs.
You can go to the limits to just not slide out, to steer as much as possible before you slide out, which creates the most amount of speed, and that shows like what would be possible if you would be really consistent at the limit.
Yeah, so good luck voting on this one, I would say. AO1 in TMNF, AO7 in TMNF, then we also had Deep Fear, Puzzle D2, Satisfaction, and Valley C15. Good luck on voting this one. This is definitely an insane category, and I'm really happy that we included it for this year. I think it's really fun. And I think the next category is also really fun. It is going to be Cut of the Year. And we always go by alphabetical order. And with that, the first one is actually going to be RPG Cut Suya in Trackmania 2020, an 111 checkpoint long RPG map with with a reroute. And the thing that we really want to showcase here is rerouting. Basically, rerouting means that you take the checkpoints in a different route. Exclamation mark Katsuya reroute in the chat if you want to take a look. This map was so complicated that it required a completely new program developed by ESFO to be able to even calculate it. I used to have a program to calculate here reroutes. You basically put in all the different checkpoint times into a spreadsheet, and then you can let the computer basically calculate what would be the best connection, basically, similar to the traveling salesman problem. If you wanna read up more on that. And I'm pretty sure my code would still not be done at this point. I'm pretty sure it would still be running at this point. So it was very crucial that Eastwood came in and developed it. Here you can see a video showcasing how it works. It is incredibly fast, so efficient. It has already found here like 3,000 to 4,000 different solutions that are incredibly fast. You just put in the data and it works on its own. And here you can also see why we included RPG Katsuya. You can see it is an incredible reroute with all the stuff that is possible. So definitely mostly a big shout out to Eastful for developing this. Of course, I myself was the one who then found the individual sections and drove the world record. The world record now is sitting at a 29. I checked. And this cut route is a whole 5 minutes faster than the no respawn time of the than the it's so a whole 5 minutes faster than the normal way. And the world record, I believe, is 3 minutes faster than the theoretical perfect run you could achieve without the reroute. So yeah, good luck beating that without doing some cuts on this track. I believe that to be probably impossible on this one. All right, but that was RPG Katsuya. Very different entry. I think it was worth to be a showcase for the rerouting and especially for the development of these tools being that drove the reroute and the cuts on these tracks. Next one we have is a DO9 obstacle by Dennis, a new TMNF cut. Of course, we are in the year 2023. Cuts will be very difficult, and in this case, it is this jump here to the right for the first time done by Dennis in this new world record right here. And I think it was I think it saved about half a second or more, actually, for the first time on this track right here. Incredible stuff. Such a difficult cut right there. And then also driving the entire rest of the map flawlessly as well. We will able to be see the comparison very soon here in the video as well. If we skip quickly to here, this is the normal route that you would have done normally, going up all the way, and you will see here, I think it's almost a second even. Yeah, it is a second, not half a second, that this cut is faster. And yeah, just really hard to perform, and Dennis was the first one to do so in 2023. Next one we have is, I think, also one that people definitely remember. It is ESL Hocolicious. A completely new reroute was found on ESL Hocolicious so many years after the map initially came out. It honestly is incredible that this is even possible to begin with. And just take a look here in the documentary done by Virtual, how it looked like, the run by Razor that eventually became the world record.
On the 15th of January, Razor got this incredible run on incredible that so long ago already.
Yeah. First of all, doing an overwall here, then getting the checkpoint from underneath, jumping to the next checkpoint immediately, another overwall onto this, already three checkpoints collected, now the fourth one here, then going to the left over the blue, jump there with the flip, keep a lot of speed here, very crucial. Then a small drift here. After this point, you will have a ramp, jump to the right, then another U-turn right here. So many checkpoints, very close to each other and very close proximity. Then another overwall here across to this checkpoint. And then just two more checkpoints to collect. So many checkpoints on this track, actually. And it's incredible how this just worked out. And then right there into the finish, driving a 50 flat. Beating the old world record by, what, 3-4 seconds, I believe. Incredible stuff on ESL Hocolicious. classic track
found
completely
by some trust, sure, basically, we'll that gave an idea to the players of what kind of line you can do, but the task was 2 seconds slower, so the players then found even better ideas and lines.
Yeah, always through cooperation, a lot of stuff is of course always possible in Trackmania, not just finding it all alone. A lot of people always always involved in these types of things. And the next one that we have now is Spring 2023-24. Everybody will definitely remember that track from just the name, but I think you will... wait, that is right here. Wait, is that... Oh yeah, no, that is, I think, correct, Spring 2023. You turn around at the start, grab a reactor, reactor flight through the checkpoint, and then another zoop right here to continue on your path. It is a Nadeo cut world record from this game. I think a very unique one, abusing the reactor physics in multiple ways. And a great run here as well.
Yeah, we made some jokes about this because it was the best map of the campaign.
Yeah,
everyone had the cut.
Yeah, of course. And the last entry that we have for cut of the year, also a Nadeo map from Trackmania 2020, and I think it is best illustrated in this clip by Virtual. Here you go.
Wait, what happened to map 13?
Yeah, medicine, doing some medicine stuff.
I thought the record was like 26.7. What?
Just going backwards, a zoop.
Oh my god, how does he
but
turn around?
But it still
around,
comes
though?
Better. I mean, he's not done yet.
He drives backwards the entire
don't
thing.
Don't out there, and then turn around with super reactor
you
up,
have to
and
be kidding.
Of course get another zoop. Why not?
That is so far.
Insane cut.
It's so much faster than the normal way. It's actually incredible.
How does that beat
the absolutely other incredible. Winter 2023-13. The new world record, or the actual world record at the end of the season, was actually 7/10 faster than that one. You will be able to find that one also in the Google form as well. And yeah, these are the cuts of the year. Katsuya Reroute, then DO9 Obstacle in TMNF, ASO Hercules, Spring 2023-24, and Winter 2023-13. All right. And now we go on to the next category in the achievements, and I think this one is one of the most important ones that we have in the award list. It is Performance of the Year.
Correct. Yeah, here we basically show off some performances where some people or teams were extremely dominant. And we start off with the first nominee being Epos at... the LAN in Razor's Summit. He was very dominant in that LAN, and in the final, he already collected 140 points and won. We saw the clip earlier when the second place was still down at 113 points, and that in the grand final.
Yeah, like Epos in general played really well over this tournament and kind of put himself on the board there, so like he deserved nominee in this spot.
The second nominee is Hawk in the United Solo Championship. This is basically also a yearly environment, a yearly cup, where in Trackmania United Forever, where the best players drive in solo against each other. And while you play basically 10 rounds on all seven environments, and second to fifth place, they were really close together, like within 27 points at like 1,100 something. But Hawk had over 200 points of a lead to all of these players and won this with 1,383 points. And the other players were people like Sander, Blackhead, and co. So very good names that he has beaten there. The third nominee is gonna be Hazard for his achievements in the Pathfinding Cup. I didn't really find the results, but just by my memory, I think in the first season of the Pathfinding and the previous year, he won every competition, like on every map. And also with that, he won the season. And then in the season final, he also won. In the second season, he was not winning every single map, but most of them. And also there he won the season final. He is just so good in the Pathfinding Cup.
Yeah, a complete domination. I have to admit, he's just incredible at this stuff. Just far above everyone else. So it's incredible what he can, what he is able to accomplish in these tracks. Just really a great, just has a great mind for finding these types of things. And yeah, really dominated, really honestly stacked competition and just winning almost every single map over and over. It's really impressive.
Yeah, anything can go wrong every time, of course. So, yeah, here we see the next one, and that is gonna be Shadowcrancer. In the spring 2023 campaign, he was absolutely dominant. Just some facts. So he won this campaign with the highest score ever achieved by a player in an official Nadio campaign, 660,000 points he achieved. And he had with that over 400,000 lead to the second place. Apart from two maps, he ended up in the top four on every other track. His worst position in the whole campaign was a 13th place, and he had overall 12 world records. Absolute domination. The fifth nominee is gonna be Scandia. In the mini RPG of the week, a season playoffs. So you know the mini RPG of the week is a weekly competition, but it has also season finals, and those also had prize money. And in the final, in the playoffs final, Scandia was far ahead of everyone else. We played reverse cup mode there, which means players go down to 0 points. They lose points every round, and then they have a last chance when they are at zero. When they get last again, they are out. When that grand final, where the four best players were part of, when that ended, he was still sitting at 65 points, starting at 100, and everyone else was already down to zero and lost. Also extremely good, like he was winning almost every round. Then the last nomination is gonna be Solary versus BDS in the Trackmania Grand League Stage 1 Grand Final. So basically, after the season of Stage 1, there were the playoffs, and BDS qualified directly into this grand final by beating Solary in the winner bracket. But then Solary came back through the loser bracket into the grand final, and basically, BDS already has basically gotten already a point for winning one match against Solary. So Solary had to win twice in a row. And what they then did is 4-0, 4-0, and then they won.
Yeah, absolute domination. They were. They also scored really well on each sub match. Basically, having to do a bracket reset in the grand final, and just they were completely relaxed, playing perfectly. And 4-0, 4-0 is just incredible in a grand final at this kind of level. They definitely were playing out of their minds at that point.
It was crazy. It was indeed very, very insane. So let's take a look on to our next category. I mean, you can see them here already, what we have said beforehand. It will be now achievements of the year. So what was notable and mentionable? What is really prestigious? What has happened last year? And here we also have a lot of things that we wrote down. I think a lot of things that are a bit predictable. But first, let's start with someone who have we already seen on a map, or we have already seen the map, but not the player. It is Eddie beating TMNF AO1 world record. I mean, Eddie has been achieving the world record also on the three of the four Trackmania 2020 campaign maps on map one. And on fall 2023, Shadowcrancer has beaten by 3/1000ths of a second. So that is crazy. But I mean, on this map, both were a 10th ahead of thirds. And I mean, this just shows how much Eddie is really grinding those first maps, and I mean, this is just a nice run here. So there you go. Very nice time beating the time from Lakada beforehand. So GG's, of course, to that. And our second nominee is Gwen winning Ascension. I mean, winning the most cash prize in Trackmania. And let's just watch the winning moment here. As this was just literally an insane denial there as well. And then we had so many finalists, also Granadi and Carl Jr. being in there, but just watch it yourself.
Altair pour l'instant premier. Altair, c'est terminé. C'est Gwen.
Biggest prize pool of Trackmania history, right there.
Yeah, Gwen like immortalizes himself there. What a great performance that was, and what a great event to watch as well. So, GG's there, of course. And let's jump into our third nominee, which is none other than Chave with his world record on Deep Dip. And I mean, this video just starts very great with someone saying, ah, why do you even try this map? And then 20 minutes later, he's in the finish with the world records. Absolute dedication and just so impressive. Like, I'm so, so flushed off this run.
Honestly, so inspirational what he is able to accomplish. The grind set really showcasing here and coming all to fruition in one run. And volume what bonding. A run it was.
And volume bonding.
Yeah. Pure reaction.
Stop playing with me, Vamos! Let's go!
He went for every single skip, for Stop every single me, cut, no matter how difficult they are. Oh, and he never took a break somewhere. He was just going full send the whole track and survived it. And that is the result. Like, look at the gap he had to second place.
Yeah, incredible stuff.
And I mean, Chave also did that with Dank Forever and also with now Falling Turtles. So he goes for those world records on all those very hard maps and just proves everyone wrong. Like, he really deserves that. And Chave also spreads a good vibe. So make sure to check him out. Just insane how much dedication went into this one. All right. Our next nominee is KC winning the world championship. I mean, I think we all remember the semifinal, but this was just a great moment of KC then dethroning Solary.
Yeah, here we see the grand final on the last track, one more round there in match point situation. And they just need to overtake one player there by the Solary team, and Bren does so.
Yeah. Was so nice. And I mean, Otak also after that one was literally just crying. I mean, it was such a great year for him. He couldn't believe it. And I mean, they almost got eliminated. They almost got eliminated in the semifinal, and then they made it.
Yeah, it was incredible scenes. So nice to see the players celebrating there. And what a moment. What a moment right there.
Really cool. Really, really nice moment. Okay, our next nominee is another one off the first map of a campaign, this time from Trackmania 2. Blue Fox, world record on AO1. And what I can say is, Riolu is dead!
Yeah, here it is. They were betting on when he was going to get it, and multiple people were already out. He's at 85 hours at this point already. Has driven 274 separate 0.5s, and the world record, of course, of 5.61 by Riolu was just missing 1,000. Of course, that Riolu record was cheated. And here you go.
Yeah, so nice.
GG, okay, I beat it, I beat.
Of course,
I
dead in game.
I fucking beat Riolu. Riolu is dead. Riolu is fucking dead.
In game.
Riolu is in-game. Dead on AO1. No more Riolu.
Incredible grind and definitely very deserved a world record there for Lufok.
Yeah, and I mean, we also had another great accomplishment in Trackmania 2020, but I think one of the most dominant Cup of the Day players, Scrappy, winning over 100 Cup of the Days, and also 5 wins in a row. Like, why not? Just winning 5 Cup of the Days in a row. Like, how mental is that? Really?
Yeah, in general,
such a skilled player.
Yeah, this is in general Scrappy's performance and achievements in Cup of the Day throughout the last year, and really has showcased himself the best player in that format.
And I mean, he's so dominant. He performs so well on most of the cups. I think has an average position of like top 16 or even top 9 or something like that. So absolutely crazy. And of course, there winning against Vixa for his 100th Cup of the Day win. Okay, we have one more nominee here as well, and it's Tenshi's PF map in a virtual.
This one was basically a connect the dots competition where virtual build a track of just like 10 checkpoints or something, and your task was to build the fastest track possible and send in a replay. Whoever gets the fastest time wins. You can build whatever you want just without block mixing, And that was basically the task at hand. There was a show to showcase who was the fastest there. So many creative players coming through, 1,000 euro prize pool, and this is what happened then.
Amazing, amazing.
Madison was second place.
From Madison. And that is why I have the honor of congratulating Madison with second place. With second place in the competition. Because there was one person who beat this time by over 1 second. By over 1 second. Driving a 26.3. And if you're doing something else right now, look away from your first monitor onto this. You are not going to want to miss this. This is one of the coolest maps I have ever seen in Trackmania. It's by Tenchi. 2636, here it is.
Watching.
Starting with the bobsleigh checkpoint. Going straight for Greenland. Jumping through that triangle. Going at full speed through this. Wall bang there. Wall bang, wall bang.
Oh my god.
Going through this, landing in that, jumping through the ring now, roof it into the water, through this triangle,
this
going
is so
full
hard
speed
to
through
build,
this plastic
like,
into North Korea,
you know,
double
the checkpoint's
360,
already there.
Down into Siberia, so, through the bottom checkpoint,
how
and
does
fly
one make
into
that? Like, insane stuff.
Yeah. Nobody thought a press forward could win in this. Like, you are allowed to drive. You would think that driving would come out as the fastest. But no, it was actually a press forward. And the finesse of building this one is insane. So much optimization throughout every single section here with plastic bounces, reactors, red boosts, water bounces as well. Like
so many triangles in a like to force the car to get this
possible. There a water section to get a wall bang a little bit earlier, and yeah, this. Double 360 is insane, and beating the second place by over a second. That was the achievements of the year. We have Eddie's world record on AO1, Gwen winning Ascension, Yava's world record on Deep Dip, KC winning World Championship, then also Lufox world record at in AO1, TM2, Tenchi's press forward in the Connect the Dots competition, and a Scrappy achieving over 100 cover day wins and also 5 wins in a row. What a category here. What
yeah,
a category.
Yeah. in this.
Yeah. There are so many, like all of these deserve to be here, and we already had to work hard to get this down to just 7, and just incredible what players have achieved in 2023, and we really want to showcase that, and I'm honestly grateful that we can showcase it here once again for anybody who have might missed some of these great achievements throughout the year. But we will go now further into the next section, which will be a bit of a shorter one. It is stories. And we will start straight with a story of the year of 2023.
All right, yeah. Let's start with the first nominee here, and that is the 20th anniversary of Trackmania. Yeah, with that 20th birthday, Nadio introduced their plan of adding the old original cars into Trackmania 2020 by using the transformation blocks. And this update then also contained many new blocks and new surfaces, for example, like wood. Around the birthday, also Rasta hosted then the Trackathon. That was an event where speedrunners could do some speedruns on all the different Trackmania games from the past and also on different game modes. For example, Trackmania Sunrise, we did a speedrun in Puzzle. All right, so yeah, Trackmania got 20 years old. That's the first nomination. Let's go to the second one, and that is Ascension. Yeah, and the Trackmania's biggest prize pool ever. This tournament, hosted by Serator, has reached new dimensions with this. Never before, players were fighting for such a huge prize pool. It was overall 128,000 euros given out to the very best Trackmania players, and with first place then getting over 62,000 alone. But there were, of course, also the stages before where they also gained already something to qualify into the finals. The next story is a cheating scandal with the snow car steering ranges. So here, with a new snow car, it got some critics, as it has, of course, disadvantages to keyboard players. With some more expensive analog keyboards, however, Virtual showed that you can map your buttons in some way, that smooth steering was then doable, and actually even more precise than what pad players could easily achieve. And this led into discussions, and the big question, how Nadeo will now handle this problem. Where's the border between using your device tools and getting an unfair advantage to other devices? The next one is the console update, the release and the updates. So Trackmania brought a lot of updates last year, and one of them made it now possible to play Trackmania 2020 also on Xbox and PlayStation. This has led to a strongly increasing number of Cup of the Day players. The maximum was on 1st of October with 6,250 players. Also the Cup of the Night had like 1K. Then also funny is the separation between the just normal Cup of the Days, and there exists now also these parallel Cup of the Days where you see players that only want to play players of their platform. You could abuse this in the beginning to get some wins, but that was changed now. And with the update for the console players, Nadeo focused then on making an easy campaign for the new players. And this was the spring 2023 campaign, which was then seen as the most boring. And
Of course, these are the stories, the most polarizing stories of the year, not necessarily the best or most wholesome or whatever. These were basically the most polarizing ones, the ones that generated the most discussion and input from the community.
Exactly. The fifth one is gonna be Ryulu losing all his world records in Trackmania 2020. This was a huge project that was in the beginning of the year, and people tried to beat all the remaining world records that Ryulu still held. And many, many sick drivers took part in hunting these records down. For example, Spam Techie and Rotaker got some old campaign records with insane runs. And also Lars, for example, hunted this track where that combined map 1 to 25 of one campaign, I remember. Like, in the end, Ryulu lost all of these world records and the project was successful. Mm. And the last
one... Also, the same thing happened in Trackmania 2 as well. Also, the Trackmania 2 world records were all beaten in the campaigns as well.
And yeah, the last one... is gonna be Scrappy's new random map survival record that he did just one day after Lars has gotten that record. Lars can maybe talk a bit more about that.
Do I have to? I guess I have to. So basically, in the entire year of random map of 2023, there were only two random map survival world records set in the entire year. One of the most... of course, a plate and most looked for categories. And it is just insane that it happened that there were a total of two world records that happened in the year. They take like 5 hours to do, and they both were set just one day apart of each other. Fun. But just incredible that that happened. Of course, I was able to beat Granadi's world record by one author time and with a record of 125 author times set in Random Map Survival. And then the day after, I think Scrappy got something like 144, an incredible run. And that they were just literally one day apart from each other is just incredible. Definitely a story of the year 2023. All right, and then we move on to the next part of the story section, which is match of the year.
All right, yeah. Here we will focus on extremely good matches, like high quality or extremely close between the players when there was a lot at stake. The first one is the 24-hour race, because this is literally so special. In 24 hours, usually one team creates like a big gap and the results are quite early clear, like who might win and so on, but not in the previous edition. Here we had basically only 11 checkpoints of a difference between the winning team and the second place after 24 hours of driving. This here is the clip of the last seconds when it then ended.
Yeah,
yeah, that was crazy. Also good to cast.
Yeah, if you think about the percentage after 24 hours being 11 checkpoints between the top two winning teams, I don't think there's any round that is closer than that or any match. It's just insane. You can see maybe slightly here at the very end, the winning team had 12,900 checkpoints. Then second place was 12,889 and a third place 12,852. Just insane how close this 24-hour race was. I think probably the closest we have ever had, and yeah, just really fun and a great tournament for sure.
Yeah, basically one checkpoint won within 2 hours.
Yeah,
that's crazy. Yeah, if you think about it,
that's like that. Insane.
Yeah, in the average,
that's like a couple of milliseconds per minute. Yeah,
yeah, if even.
Our second nomination, it had to be in here, obviously. It is the Ascension Grand Final.
And here we have it one more time. Of course, we saw it earlier already, multiple times already showcased. Yeah.
This was, of course, a highly awaited match. And before it was won by Gwen, 6 out of these 8 players were in the finalist mode. So 6 out of the 8 players had the chance with one round win to get that huge prize pool. That was so extreme, the tension was extremely high in this.
Yeah, and here we can see, just let's just watch the final run again with Gwen. Yeah, it is just incredible. So tight between all the players and so many finalists, just so exciting stuff.
Ah. So many denies as well to the early finalists. You can see already see 4 finalists, but Gwen,
yeah, Gwen now Gwen then of course winning when there were 4 finalists denying. And then the 6 players finalists when it was finally decided.
Yeah, and Arthur wasn't, and he was very good on this track. He was denying already in the first round, but here Gwen passed him at the final chance.
And of course, Granadi also getting second.
Yeah.
Also cool.
Junior second.
And
Granadi was then third. Yeah. Yes.
He was in the money, never mind. Yeah, yeah. But it was very close in general. And I mean, then the points decided who got a second and third, yeah. True that.
All right, our third nominee, and we have seen a clip from it already. It is the Ifrei Grand Final.
Aurel!
Yeah, I think this final finalist round speaks for itself for the Ifrei Grand Final.
For Binks, can Glass try to pull something together? It's a great set. No, China will do it. Aurel! Aurel!
Like,
it's time for
not
BDS!
Think that would make it there.
We are winners.
Incredible.
To understand why this was so crazy as well, you have to understand what the format was. So basically, you had 4 teams battling it out in the final. All 4 teams had 2 drivers, and they were together collecting points until they, as a team, got to a point score. With that, they got finalists. And when they were finalists, then both drivers still had to win a run.
Yep.
To actually win for the team. Balling and at the point round. Of this round,
oh,
we had already,
goodness.
Like everyone was finalist, and 3 teams had already a player through. So that means that 3 teams were already with one player away from winning this thing, and one team still had 2 players that had to win. So it was the second to last or the last round it meant to be for getting the winner.
Yeah, incredibly close right there, and then what a final round that was.
Yeah. All right, our next nominee here is this time. Also, we started, of course, with like complete matches. Here we have now just one map, and that is the overtime from Solary versus Big in the TMGL. This was actually ending up in a 17 to 14.
It is one of the most difficult
Let's
wins I've
hear what Virtual says for. About it. You also see some what? Highlights.
Yeah, you just talked about it.
Yeah, and then let's right go there. Maybe shortly back.
Now the difference is nullified. It's all equal. Back into the wall. Big are going to finally break through. But it is one of the most difficult wins I've seen a team have to fight for. What a match on pool.
Yeah, 14 to 17 overtime. So many draws in a row. Incredible pace on this one. And like really, really tight rounds that were able to be seen on
yeah,
that one.
And multiple world records happening yeah. in this single submatch.
That as well.
Yeah, it was crazy. All of the rounds were close. All of the rounds had... many had world records, incredible, and then up to 14-14, like with four draws in a row, crazy. All right, the next nominee is the Random Track Generator Cup Grand Final.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hope
in
you're
this
ready for
Cup. We had 10 players, and when the winner was crowned, it was already a triple finalist situation. But the fight for second place was not over. After some denies, actually six players were in finalist mode. Until then, someone finally has won that second place.
Yeah,
and that one was actually
really
just getting into finalist with exactly 1,000 points. Like on the point he got there, denying in the, rounds in the round before to get finalist and then getting second.
Yeah. It was a really close Energize match decided on randomly track generated maps and was very very close in finalists, so many finalists at the end and was really exciting. Really exciting stuff.
Yeah, and the last one, we had to of course also include one match from the World Championship. And that is the semi-final. You all know it by ITB and KZ.
Oh yeah.
This will yeah. come down
I mean,
to
yeah,
the
this is the first map, by the way, which was already crazy. But of course, the ending of the match that we will show off later as well in the nominees, like in the award show, wasn't even crazier than this.
I think about this match, everybody will still talk even like in 5 years. I mean, even though it's a sweet bitter taste, but in general, also the level. I mean, you can see this round here in particular. The pressure was insane, and then I mean, ITB and KC just went for overtime. I'm on map one already, and well, and then Bren also fails to jump.
Yeah, this was another draw
so,
here.
Yeah, it's just 13-13 draw on the
13-13, yeah.
On the very first map already, just so close. Such a insane semifinal. They had everybody on the edge of their seats. And in the end of the day, the winner of the winner of this match did was crowned the world champions, of course.
Yeah, that is for sure.
Yeah, here we can see once again the match of the year contestants were 24-hour race, Ascension Grand Final, Ifray Grand Final, Overtime versus between Solovey and Big, RTG Cup Grand Final, and the World Cup semi-final between ITB versus KC. Now to the last category that we have in Stories of the Year, and that is Comeback of the Year. The greatest comebacks that have happened in matches in the previous year, and presented once again by Marius.
Yeah, exactly. Comeback, we had it, I think, once in the Trackmania Awards, but many years ago. Yeah, now it's back, and there are some really good comebacks. We start off with Azox, his loser bracket run at XP Evo. This is now one of the matches, the second to last in the loser bracket, I think loser bracket final, where Sturzen himself and Piranha triple final situation, and he got through here. But beforehand, he was a bit behind in that match and made the comeback and got through with that. And in the match afterwards, the same thing happened. He was again behind, but again he got up to finalists and got through it. In both cases, together with his brother Barbos, they went on into the consolidation match.
Yeah, it was such a great story. I was so emotional when I was casting it, when Azox went through. It was really cool. So just the brotherhood there prevailing, really nice.
Yeah, the next nominee here is now from a whole series. that was basically turned around under this Exalti versus Orcs in the Trackmania League Challenger. In this match, what you have to know, it was Playday 7 of Season 1 in the Challenger League, and Exalti was actually 3-0 down. But then they turned it around and won it 4-3 in the end.
Yeah, and here we can also...
The last two maps with a 10-9 and a 10-7 score.
Yeah, it was a very crucial match for them, for Exalti. Had a lot of losses before and they really wanted to prove themselves, and they were already 3-0 down and then coming back and winning it 4-3. Just incredible stuff by the players to do such a comeback in such an important point for them in the esport career.
Yeah, and that didn't happen just once. Also in the Trackmania Challenger League in Playday 6, also one Playday earlier, we saw that between Sprout and Hominotsun, which is the next nominee. Also here, Sprout was 3-0 down after losing 11-7, 11-8 and 10-9. And then still turned it around into a 4-3 win. And this these four map wins had also an 11-10 win and a 10-8 win. This is now the last map.
Yeah, then here it got decided, and Sprout really had the momentum at that point. And yeah, they only needed one more point in this round with a Scrappy getting a second place. That was enough, and they managed to turn it around and win 4-3 in that match.
Yeah, as the caster that just said, like, they did the impossible.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, the next one is Granadi with a comeback in the second Ascension event, in the qualifier, basically in the finals there. The mode that they used there in this final was that everyone had three lives. And when you get last place, you lose a life. If you have zero lives, you're out. Granadi was very early on one life only, but then he kept staying alive all the way through into the grand final. Afi for a long time still had all three lives, and it ended up in this run.
All came down to the cut, so Granadi. Yeah. With a great one there, and I mean, just winning the second Ascension qualifier, and I mean, at the end, we've already seen that so often, also getting third place in the final.
Yeah, incredible stuff, great comeback from the German player for Berlin International Gaming. Alright, and the next one is going to be also featuring Berlin, or Big.
Yeah, after now seeing comebacks in basically matches, we now have a comeback in a single map. And that is Big with three aces in a row against Solary. That was actually crazy because Big, as you see, was 9-2 down. And this is the round where it could have been over already. But Granadi, with a full send in the last identity jump, passes Carl Jr. and brings it to a 9-5. If we skip a bit further in the VOD.
We jump to the end of the next round, and here we see also Granadi and Massa once again on great pace on first and second. Can they keep it up through the identity? And yes, they do. Getting another ace.
Close it is, like, it is not the thing that Solary fails here. At the times were incredible, 0.2 and low 0.4. It was just Big surviving three rounds in a row with both drivers on an incredible pace. And that's the only way how you can actually do that against Solary. And this is then the final round. Can maybe skip a bit further.
Yeah, and of course, going to the end of this one right here. And once again, it's so close. Carl Jr. in the fight with Granadi and Massa. Three rounds in a row, they are playing at such a great level.
From 2-9 to 11-9 against Solary. Three aces in a row.
And it was even match point for them as well. So, incredible.
Exactly, they won basically the second match from the series. The first one went to Solary, and then it went to the decider, which then Big won. So it was very crucial. It was super crucial to win this whole thing. This was the semi-final, I think, in the playoffs. And with that, Big went into the grand final of stage 2. Yeah, all right. And then we go to the last nominee in this category, Comeback of the Year, and that is a comeback of Bren within the single round now. So this is a comeback in a single round. You see it here. A very important map for Gwen, because this is he was choosing this map, like people could choose the map, and he was choosing, of course, his favorite tube map, so he had to score well here. It was crucial, and then he made this mistake, but what followed now?
Just an insane ending.
Yeah, such a difficult map on stage with all the pressure, with the crowd and everything. And you have been training these maps for months at this point.
I still believe that Gwen doesn't know the concept of pressure. That he just plays like a psycho, but well.
Look at that transition there. Overtaking everybody from last to first.
Kicking things off with another 10 points for himself. That is a champion.
And right there, that was the final comeback of 2023. Here we can see them all once again. Azog's loser bracket run at XP Evo, Exorti versus Orcs turning a 3-0 to a 3-4. Same thing with Sprout versus Huminitsune. Ganadi in the second Ascension qualifier. Second quali, being immediately down to just one heart, but still managing to win it. Biggs, three aces versus Solvi, and also the Bren comeback in that very crucial Ascension round. Now we go to the next category. There are two categories or sections left only, and two really important ones, I think, and really fun ones especially. The next one is going to be moments. After that, it's going to be people, so stuff like player of the year. So now we're really getting to the nitty-gritty of the award show, and I think these ones, there are multiple new categories that we are going to be including here in the moments of the year, multiple new categories that we have not had in previous years that we think deserve recognition. And I think they're also just very fun and exciting to look through. I think they are very interesting what happened in 2023. And we're starting off with Clip of the Year. And the very first one is Granadi Peng Peng Peng. And here you go. What a clip this was.
Also great reaction from Spam, of course.
It's a classic.
That's for sure. I think the reaction makes it even better.
Yeah, just look at his webcam. Just a great clip right there. For the first one. Next one is going to be a very special one. Not as many people have seen it, but we felt like it deserved some recognition. It is the only time that Hazard streamed his Pathfinding Cup point of view. We had him earlier in Performances of the Year, how he has been dominating it. And now we saw how he is actually dominating it. How is possible? Just look at what he did.
He could also just play the lottery at this point, I think.
Yeah, fair.
So this is actually the way you have to get there.
Yeah,
that's not like this.
Not like this, but he actually manages it and gets a cut basically like this with that bounce upside down. Only time that he ever streamed. And that's how it looks like. Very interesting. Then the next one, if you have followed the channel, you will know about this one.
That's so good.
Police cut.
It's such a good clip.
Yeah, I was forced to include this one. I didn't want it, but Turbo and Marius was very adamant about this one.
Enjoy it now.
Wait, what?
So
wait, huh?
Clueless.
Wait, what? What is everybody doing?
So I mean, Lars, I think you thought that.
Yeah,
got every checkpoint.
Yeah, I went past this finish here. This was also in the Pathfinding Cup, just as the other one. I knew there was a finish here, and I come to this checkpoint, and I know how to get there. And wait, checkpoint 15, I have all the checkpoints, right? So I just turn around and think, wait, nobody figured that out yet. Wait, I'm winning this. I'm getting second place. I'm making the comeback of the year right here. Instead, it landed in clip of the year.
At least somewhere, right? And the reaction is so good when you realize that you messed up.
Next one is Massa Exceptional. Here we go. Of course, one of the most important ones. I love that they did that. So cool. That they just recorded a music video for it is so sick.
This is so good.
What a moment right there. That is a massa clip. Next one, clip that really went viral, also from the Ascension Cup or this Ascension tournament. Also spam type one. It is spam reacting to Mudder's cut as he got through in the finalist round. What a clip right here. Insane moment.
Oh my god. Lufox stays in first place though.
He didn't know about this cut, I think.
Mudder with more speed through the bobsleigh. One turn remaining. No way!
And he makes it.
He is him.
Crazy.
What a clip right there. Really went viral, especially. It has like 170,000 views or something like that. Absolutely crazy. What the hell? That is... I am not logged in. That is normal YouTube recommendation. I am not logged in. That is just complete normal YouTube. What the fuck? Thanks, YouTube. What? Okay.
Interesting.
Okay, clip of the year. The next one, we have one more. Yeah, we have clip of the year 2024. Shit. Okay, next one, we have Tom at XP Evo. Okay. Here you go.
All right, so you're voting against Granati.
I love this one.
And Scrappy. Okay, all right. Interesting. Okay. Shorty, surely you won't get canceled over your answers. Let's go with you next.
Also, a nice shot, TVS.
I'm just gonna say Ratchet and okay?
Live broadcast of the event.
What a handsome man. Wow. Oh my. We're getting a little too much.
So good. So good. Incredible stuff.
It's so good.
Craziest thing for me personally is I was sitting here. I stood up for like 2 minutes or something. Then when I come back, everybody's like instantly going at me. You have no idea what you just missed. Like,
I was in the casting booth and was just giggling, I think. That was fun. Mm.
That was a clip of the year. We have Granati, ping, ping, ping. Hazard's lucky sweats in the Pathfinding Cup. Me thinking that I finished. Massa, exceptional. Spam reacting to Mudder's cut. And Tom at XP Evo. Incredible stuff there. That was a clip of the year. Really fun category. Next one is a bit more serious once again. It is round of the year.
Yeah, round of the year. I mean, we had a lot of great rounds. And let's just get things started. Ascension, Granati versus Afi is our first nomination. I mean, it was just an intense battle. I mean, Granati doing the 360. We have already seen that round beforehand where we talked about Granati's performance on this final. And it was just a great round. So watch it here again.
Yeah, it was an elimination based format here. And both of them were on one life. This final round decided everything, basically. The entire qualifier.
Decided who wins, I think, was it like 6,000 or something?
Yeah,
like that.
Something like that.
So like Granati with a great 360 there and lands
even anymore. But that section.
Afi is still ahead. And there's only one thing.
We saw it earlier already.
They both have to cut it. Or it's like difficult to decide what to do. But they both invented it.
And look at how happy he was. Like, really cool. Probably one of the like probably the best day for Granati in his career. Maybe after Ascension final.
Next one is
Yeah, and the next one already, you can already see it on the screen. Carl Jr. versus Mime. A double tied situation there. So let's also watch that clip and then go more into context.
Again, look
and
at
see
this.
What
Alcon
happened there. I mean,
it's
a nice match between Story and ITB. And I mean, this was very important, but also Carl Jr.
Yeah, very important thing. First of all, Mime is 500s in front here in this checkpoint in front of Carl Jr. Next checkpoint, they are tied on the thousands. 3-2-6, both of them. And now coming into the finish right here, they're also tied. They are also tied.
What? How it works is if you are tied in the finish, then the last checkpoint matters. But there they were also tied. So the pre-last checkpoint mattered. And this is
this one right here. Yeah. Who and went first? Yeah. Yeah. Who got first into this checkpoint, which was Mime, that decided it at the end. That checkpoint right there. And of course, it's impossible to notice that when it's live that both of them were equal here, but insane how close that was and how that was decided. That checkpoint there decided it in that one.
Very
close.
Unlikely. And I mean, then also an ace, of course.
Yeah, of course. Just
much
also
more advantageous.
Yeah, yeah, also just a good round in general.
Yeah. And then also another round where I had to look 3, 4, 5 times is Ascension, Coco versus Snow. I mean, was a high-pressure round. You can see it because so many mistakes have also happened. But I mean, everyone is kind of in final situation other than Dinosaurs, and whoever makes it will go through.
Yeah, this was the semi-final and probably the last one of the semi-final deciding who goes into the grand final. So the biggest pressure situation possible for the players. And it was just so close between these two.
Yeah, then also now in the ending, this risky jump is not too easy, and then both like messing up a little bit here, Snow hitting the wall, but then also Coco. Yeah, Coco also not too far ahead, and now Snow capitalizing on the Snow slide, and he's ahead, but it's still decided. It was so close, and I thought that Snow had it because he finished earlier, but no, it was Coco staying ahead, and you can see his pure reaction there as well.
Just great stuff.
Yeah, and it like just summarize everything. Pressure situation, making mistakes, but still being able to catch up. Now we have another great round from the Danish Championship, which was just an absolute close round. And also great casting from Jane there, so let's watch that one.
Okay, so we have...
Yeah, I think this is just a work of art from the players in this round, how close it was.
Yep.
Four players right here, fighting it out on a very technical map.
Both Woob and Nikolic in the red.
In the end,
oh, Nikolic getting a lot of speed out of that one. What a
Nico
beautiful setup there.
Comes back
for
with
the
an
outside,
outside
line.
He's ahead now,
first.
But I mean, it's like so close though.
But Woob is up there with them. They're both driving this map super fast.
It's
they
back
know
and
they
forth,
have nothing else but full sending that they can do here. They cannot afford to not send it. All the players are neck and neck. Who's gonna get the final? Oh no! It's
look
gonna
at
be
that.
Getting a
200s deciding it.
Third.
Yeah.
And Woob in last, and Jake Ray winning.
He was already in last chance, I think. Woob got knocked out with that.
Yeah. Jake Ray 26, then Zuligans 14,000, Nikolek 19,000, and Woob 28,000. Absolutely insane.
Yeah, insane stuff there. So definitely worth mentioning this round. Then we have the Air Fry Cup winning round. I mean...
yeah, I mean, we have shown it most of the times. I mean, Aurel, you know, that's it. You know it. We have seen it. It's incredible. Just incredible. And I can watch this over and over. It's just... especially also heightened by the reaction by the casters. It's just...
my demon was
already here. He must have had the ending of his life.
But also a glass with a mistake.
Aurel!
Best speed for Brandon.
For BDS! They are winners!
4,000s in the end, it was between them, by the way.
Yep, absolutely insane. And then the last one is Schweine Aim Ace to get the map win.
Yeah, that one was also great.
So, aktuell.
Also, nice reaction from Trilux. And of course, very hard landing there to gap.
Yeah, it was a really important round here for them against alternate attacks in this challenger round.
It looks like attacks would take the map win here, 8-7, and they have 1 and 2 in this round. Now there is a small chance.
Das wäre noch gut, das wäre noch gut. Jetzt kann dir vielleicht down gehen.
And also the ending was notoriously hard here.
Push, Richard, push!
and Scandio gets the slowdown. So it is Ratchet overtaking here, and also Scandio struggling, but Ratchet sniping him barely in the end. So this was so important, also for the map win to go to the lead 2-0.
I love Trilux's reaction plan.
Yeah, it's so good. It will not be the last time that we're gonna see Trilux here, so that's for sure. Alright, so there are our nominees again. It's Ascension Coco versus Snow, Ascension Granati versus Afi, then Carl Jr. versus Mime with a double tie where the checkpoints really mattered. The Danish Championship, this very close round, 300ths of a second. FRI Cup winning round, RL! And then the Schweinheim Ace in the end that you have just seen. Okay, let's go to the next category, which is Throw of the Year. So also a new one that we put in. And the first one, also a bit of a more or less fun one because it looks very silly, is Azox versus Loco in the Cup of the Day final.
Yeah, just check this one out. You wouldn't know why this category exists.
Depends. But you could say the same, like if Gwen played every Cup of the Day.
It was so risky Carl, also by Azox, but it...
Wait, it's final. I didn't even
pay attention.
No! No!
Oh, he's back.
Nice!
Awesome!
No! Oh,
so no way! What the fuck?
Yeah, huh? Wasn't during the Call of Duty final, of course.
Finish.
And Loco winning against Azox. Well, and another one is Biggs, who's on the list. It's a water bounce on a very notorious map as well.
Yeah, they had a very easy A situation 3 seconds ahead here. then somehow manages to miss the safe finish in the water pool.
Yeah, it can happen if you like hit the beam like this.
Yeah, very, very unlucky there. But yeah, losing the ace with that, quite unfortunate.
Yeah. Then we have another one, which is a triple crash in match point situation. So,
together with Bing,
this one was
so
just
far,
insane as well, like, Gamers First versus KC, and everything came down to the last turn, and Spam's reaction was so good.
It's match point for both teams, 8-8, the draw would just continue, but if any team wins now, it's over, and Bren does lose time here, and it's a 1-2 situation for G1. Looks safe, right?
With the mistake early on.
Surely, yeah. Then Gwen crashes.
But yeah, Bings crashes and Bren crashes as well, and Otak subbed first.
No, like, everything happened there in the end. Like, absolutely insane. Wow, that was
and from the Gamers First victory, it turned into KC winning this.
Yeah, absolutely insane. And what a good clip as well. Like, I love the reaction.
And then we have another one. El Clasico. Granati versus Scrappy in Cup of the Day. Let's jump into the clip and see what happened there. So it was during a full sweep map, and it looked like Granati is going to win it, but there was just a little bit of a problem. I mean, also Scrappy here, not with the best speed. You know, losing a lot on that, but then Granati kind of not getting the best line there, and Scrappy sniping it by just a couple of thousands and winning the cup.
Let's watch the video until we see Granati's reaction to that as well.
3 seconds of a second.
Bootcamp with Massa at that point.
And he tried to save it, but he lost by 3,000ths.
By 3,000!
Comes after Scrappy.
What happened?
Scrappy, of course, happy about it.
Yeah. Like, I think he got an auto slide and had to dodge the pole on the outside line.
It was a great save, actually, by Granati, but...
No way!
Yeah, it was a really good save, but then 3,000ths.
What a fun round there.
Yeah. And now my favorite clip because of the reactions, guys, volume warning. Schweinheim double finish fail.
Oh god, this is
like, guys,
this,
like volume warning. Like I speak it out here. So we have again here a map that you're all aware of. It is back and forth. Ratchet and Barbos both ahead, but there's still a finish triangle to clear.
Oh, schön outside my bar.
Oh mein Gott.
Oh,
das ist unlucky. Ich hab denselben gemacht, egal.
So good. That's such a raw scream. It's just so funny. Oh my God.
It could be very German.
Okay, well.
Yeah, one more.
Okay, we have the snow finish bunk as well as our last clip of throw of the year. And, I mean, this one was also, I mean, the round was already over. But, but then snow kind of forgot to turn and could not drive a straight line. I mean,
yeah, you can
vortex.
Yeah, you can see it here. They're just coming to the finish. It's a very simple finish after this identity. The identity is basically over. You could have placed the finish there already. Would not really make a difference normally.
And snow crashes on the inside.
What are you doing?
And gets last instead of the ace.
I've never seen
and gives also orcs the chance to
why would you
not completely lose his map.
You have the
That was throw of the year right there. Azog versus Luka in the cover day final. Binx water bounce in the easy ace situation. G1 double fail in the last turn on the double match point situation. Ganadi versus Crappy. Schweine aim double fail and finish bonk by snow in the lead as well. Another ace. A loss right there. But next round we have, and if this was the throw of the year, now we have funniest round of the year.
All right, yeah, before we start, some of the nominees of these two categories, we could also switch around. Basically, in throw of the year, we focused more like on one side failing an easy, safe victory, kinda. Here, there were either multiple fails or the reaction, even though that was also funny partly in the other videos, the reaction here was then also one of the reasons. The first one is Bestia versus Jazzy in the Cup of the Day in a top three round. Let's head into it.
Yeah.
Now, but look at this, like, where is he going?
Peak Div 1 gameplay right here, I can tell you already.
Where are you going?
What was that even?
Oh no, Sly, what do you see? No!
And then he just continues accelerating.
Bro, there is no way! Bro, if Carl doesn't win
classic.
This...
And then this
and then this happens.
And then snipe.
600s. Oh god.
Like they both didn't want to win. I think they both just didn't want to. Yeah, okay. The second nominee is now we put it now in here. It is YanTM with a triple tie in three rounds in a row. So we have to go the backstory first. Let's head into it. This is the first round. It is in the Nations Cup and the campaign maps, Germany versus Spain. It was a community map pack, I think. And YanTM ties here for first place. With
der eine von denen ist gecrashed.
Now we can move a bit further in the video to the end of the second round. That came right after, and we see YanTM on third place, on tying with his own teammate Chroma right here. And now comes the next round, and he managed to actually tie for a third time in a row, but not just one player. Now he was even part of a triple tie with Techtreams and with one Spanish player CA, and Techtreams and YanTM, they both got second and third place because of the name. And with that, Germany won this round.
It looks
because CA, who had the same time as second, got only fourth. And Germany got the point here.
Yeah, incredible that this happened. The likelihood of this happening ever is just so low. Three ties in a row, on the thousands especially in this game, is just... actually crazy that this happened. And a lot of people, of course, missed this one, so I think it was important for us to include it here in the nominations, because it's just the likelihood of this ever happening is just basically zero.
All right, so the next one is Massa surviving in the Cup of the Tay.
No way.
And we
I'm like a
see
small
here
tier in my ear. Oh yeah, I'm so out.
Also, Granadi was in that voice chat.
Looks good, looks good.
Cup of the day.
Granadi, you need a good end.
Okay.
Yeah, you need like a really good end. Okay, Massa's out. No! Go, Massa! What are you
doing? And this one's crazy.
Like both just refusing to respawn.
Yeah, respawn, you guys never finish, give up. Man. Never give up. And then Mess are still in because
Nuke
has no speed.
Dude, you're in no way.
Respawn there as well.
Plus 15.
Oh my god.
Spam can't handle it.
No way, what the?
Really can.
No. How are you ever plus 15?
My guy just jumped out of the map.
Ilona, why are you spamming so much in spam chat?
Alright, the next one is the famous map Slippy Slides. It had actually two cool clips, one from the Challenger League, but we show here one from the Trackmania
Grand League.
Guys,
ITB is gonna win here.
Another
focus spam
up,
guys,
clip.
Focus up now. Wait, Sinners with the comeback.
I mean, this map was just content.
Yeah, it was content.
Yeah, this one is just too good.
And so hard as well, because you cannot adjust.
It's not over.
And he fires it onto the hole.
And Mime gets first with that.
Yeah. Absolutely insanity.
Yeah. The next one is Sprout with a double pole hit. It's a very short clip by Massa.
They are 1 and 2 unless they both hit the wall.
Yep.
Yeah, there's also another clip. He said basically it's basically GG. They are 1 and 2.
Yeah, it's basically GG. It's 1-2.
They both hit the wall.
I remember casting that match as well.
Yeah,
I was also jinxing them there. Yeah.
Yeah, and the last one is an absolute banger. Trackmania.
Up right there, but now beat Mime's record.
Off-road.
Let's do it again. Let's
and missing this CP is just one of the things. There were a lot of things beforehand. The double slide out, for example. But what happens later is just incredible. So you see Enor crashing here as well. It's an easy ace.
All Wasile has to do is finish an alternate attack. They could be looking at an ace.
Surely.
Yeah, I mean, it's a classic. You get a record on the board and you're fourth place.
And Vosal misses.
Oh, Vosal missed the checkpoint.
And
he has to reverse and get it again.
Oh
my, what is
out.
Happening?
Yeah.
Wait, Vosal is stuck on the penalty, guys. Ain't no way.
So he has
man,
no
is
speed.
So stuck.
Oh no.
Yeah, and now feet comes
Vosal,
to the end as well into that MT.
He's so close.
Has
oh,
more
no,
speed than
Vosal. Oh no, it's another tree. Oh no,
he crashes into two trees as well. Oh my god. That was funniest rounds of the year. We have Basti versus Jussie in the cover day, Jan's triple tie, Massa surviving the cover day round, Slippy Slides Identity, Sprout double pole it, and also missing the checkpoint. All right, and now we have one last category in the moments, and it is a new one as well. We haven't had this one before, but we felt like for that year it was required. It's Bug of the Year. We have Bug of the Year as a category. And it was even hard to get this down to only six. We have Bug of the Year. And we're starting off. Very first one is the 1000th track of the day or cover of the day. It didn't work. Because the map file was too big because they added a screenshot. And then the map file was too big to be loaded onto servers. And the cup of the day, for the 1000th time, just didn't work. Nobody could play it. So, unlucky,
yeah.
I would say.
He did big announcements as well. Yeah. Especially the cup of the day. Because it's the 1000th track of the day. It's truly super special. And then
it just didn't work. Then, I mean, you have been waiting for this one. It's pretty hard to showcase this one. ITB, a double bug in the semi-final
through that final
right here.
And head in hand, RB and Mime,
yes.
Sebastian from there. And
I mean,
Ruben
getting this bug is like a 1 in 100 kind of
Mime
thing. And both
no
players
way,
getting
no
it
way,
there.
No way,
yeah,
no
they landed
way,
on a very specific point on the wall, right? But then landing bugging
respawn,
and like that. You can't really avoid it.
Into match
and
point versus match point.
Actually.
It's actually okay, fair enough. The second wall ride will be the one to qualify the coming.
Bren also gets the bug right after the next round. Bren also got the bug.
We go into overtime.
What is
going on?
But then KC won.
Yeah, another.
So it was still unlucky for ITB, of course.
Yeah.
Because they were the first
ones. Yeah, there's definitely more unlucky there. Another bug of the year, this time from myself. This was on a track that I was playing for 8 hours. It was an only up type of map, or similar to Deep Dip, no checkpoints. And after 8 grueling hours, I was finally at the finish, ready to complete this map and never see it again. And this is what happened.
And that's it. Speed.
Yeah, skill issue.
I boxed!
Unlucky.
Literally the last single thing that could have happened, and I bugged right in front of the finish. After 8 hours.
Yeah, wait, you got recalled again.
Yeah. the next one is snow update cover day not working. Once again, another update, another big thing by Nadeo, and the cover day does not work. And we can especially see here in the video. Okay, you can hear it really well from Shorty right there. Yeah, if we look at the end tier, yeah. You just get all the checkpoints, you come to the finish, and nothing happens. You see a bunch of cars just sitting there. Yeah, you had all of the checkpoints, but it just didn't trigger. It was an issue for the first two snow couple of days. Later it was fixed, but of course, unfortunate that that did not work there. Next one. This time from XP Evo, Tween, getting one of the weirdest, strangest landing bugs we have seen in the bobsleigh at the end of this map in final situation against Azox.
It's only a couple of lariats left where you can really make a mistake. Keep the car out of that wall. Will do so. There's great speed on Tween coming through from behind as well. My god, I don't know where the camera is. Azox dodged in the middle of it as well.
No, Tween is clear of the mistake.
Clear of the mistake. In the bobsleigh.
He doesn't. I do not. Azox
just surviving those things like 3 times. Final situations.
Yeah. And the last one that we have for bug of the year is Virtual losing the Cup of the Day final on the finish line because of his internet lagging out. You can see right here, he's coming to the finish. He is in front of Yannex coming into the finish now. He had more speed. Drives to 0.70, but then changes to 85.
Ah, GG. I thought I was first. I got baited. I went a little too wide. That was still a good run though. 40.8.
Because the Yannex played with cars on.
Yeah. You see here, it's first 0.70.
Why does it say I finished with a 0.70?
And then it changes to an 85.
My timer.
You can also see.
Clocks in up.
Here. The clip by Yannex. You see Virtuous in front. And he just wins. Just wins. Alright, and that is bug of the year. We have the 1000th track of the day not working, the ITB double bug in semifinal of the World Championship, the finish jump or bugging on the finish jump, snow update not working, the Tween landing bug in XP Evo in double finals as well, always seems to attract in those most important rounds, and also Virtual in the final of the cup of the day. Yeah, but we have one last category still remaining, and one of the most exciting ones, I think. It is people. Basically, anyone from streamer, player of the year, and stuff like that.
Yeah, so first of all, we're going to start with casters, the caster of the year. And we have this, we have had that quite often, and we decided on 5 nominees in this category. And the first one is Boney. Boney has been a like very, very like just insane caster, and also like just bringing things with a lot of comedic value to it. So he is just a blast to hang out with, but also a very, very good caster, casting XP Evo Racer Summit as well in Schreveningen, or however it's pronounced, Mini RPG of the Week, Chamax as well. So he has been very active, and also with the Finnish Trackmania League, he has been doing a lot of that stuff. So happy to have him in the community. Our second nominee is a no-brainer, my fellow colleague at the World Championship. It is Mr. Geek. He is extraordinarily talented, casting in both English and French, and just having so many competitions that he attended in person, but also casted online. I mean, F-Ride Trackmania Cup, Insalan as well, and then 95 King of the Fields, and then also XP Evo and Trackmania World Tour, the World Championship, just to name a few. So a very talented caster in both French and English.
Yeah, and maybe one thing to add for Geek is that last year he was doing a commentating of a run by Lewis Hamilton, and he won the competition there, which meant that he was then able this year to attend the testing phase of Formula One at Bahrain and also meet the real commentators there in Formula One. So it shows how good he is, and he really follows the stream.
Yeah, he's such a good caster that he was invited by Formula One to come to their event. And if that doesn't speak something, then I don't know what will. That is insane.
He's just such a talent, and I mean, just happy to have someone like this in the Trackmania scene. Always a pleasure to cast him with him. Our third nominee is someone who has been really shining through in 2023, and that's why I think nominating him is really worth it. It is Kriti. Kriti, also an extraordinary talented caster, was also very involved in the Trackmania World Tour, especially during the All-Star Championship and also Stage 1 and 2. Doing the regionals, but also in the Challenger League, he was casting on the official Trackmania channel, if I recall that correctly, or Fastpoint, something like that. But then also Comic-Con Baltics, he casted together with me, but he has been improving a lot and also just being a great host and just has a good understanding of the game as well, because he's also not the worst player himself. So happy to mention him here as well. All right, coming to the penultimate nominee, someone also rather new in the scene, but also so talented, so gifted, it's Nualake. Started off with a mini RPG of the week, of course, casting every week when he can, but then also being very active in the Challenger League, as well as the EU regionals of Turkmenia World Tour Stage 1, and then I got to cast together with him at the All-Star Championship, and I just noticed, wow, this guy is a great host. You can learn a lot from him, but also a very good commentator. He comes from Rocket League, so he was not really that used to Trackmania, but still, he was able to just bring so much knowledge over this game. And I mean, him coming from Britain, he also casted the British and Irish Professional League Season 2, and also attended XP Evo, of course, which I've casted the final together with him.
I will take over the last entry here because it is, of course, our fellow Luckers Turbo, who just commentated himself. Basically, a no-brainer decision here as well. Has casted basically anything that has happened in Trackmania in 2023. And also, of course, casted the World Championships, the highest form of one of the highest form of tournaments that we had in the previous year. No-brainer to include Turbo as well for Caster of the Year. And with that, we have then Boni, Gigi, Kriti, Nualuk, and also Turbo.
Yeah, those are our nominees. I mean, it's always weird to just reveal yourself. I think I did that once, so thank you for taking that one over. And we now go into the next category, which is also a new one, and I think a quite interesting one. It is Small Streamer of the Year. And you guys might wonder, okay, why is this category there? We will have Streamer of the Year after that as well. But I think, like, who had a breakthrough year? Like, who got partnered? Like, who just increased their view counts? Who established themselves? And there we also listed five streamers. The first one is our favorite Turkish streamer. It is Birdie, who definitely deserves to be on this list, hosting the Birdie of the Day, playing Cup of the Day, or Cup of the Morning, rather, and also building, just being very involved in Trackmania, also now with the Trackmania Turbo that he's doing. I think he's already at 170 plus SDM medals, so very cool to seeing him. And of course, never enter a stream with 100% volume.
Yeah, this was a very important category for us because we really want to showcase all of these great streamers who provide so much content to the community. How we decided this one was basically under 200 viewers is the cutoff for this one, average exactly. For 2023. That was the cutoff that we used.
Yeah. Okay. So just under 200, or just who just had a breakthrough year, because I think Down sometimes has even more than 200, which gives us our next nominee. I mean, Down, AR Down, also got partner, I think, last year and started streaming very late as well. I mean, he has just really built a like found a good community during Cup of the Night as well. So it is really, really good to seeing this, and I mean just a very chill and nice player and streamer, and also wins so many Cup of the Nights. It's incredible. All right, third nominee, and we already mentioned him, and I think soon to be partner as well. It is Chave the Demon. Like, good vibes, can talk about every topic, great music taste, and just a lot of dedication. And I think Chave the Demon is definitely worth to mention, just trying to push the boundaries further and further. I mean, I played Dank Forever with him. I didn't finish. He did. Definitely deserved to be on this list. Chave, absolute great guy.
No, next one, Tarpor, yeah. Type 1.
Tarpor Type 1. So Tarpor, of course, also started streaming somewhat regularly during 2023 and really established himself also in the early stages of the day for EUFrog. So Tarpor is also nominated here. Some requests, good vibes in the chat as well, and just going through the variety of Trackmania content as well. Always great to be there. Always very nice. And our last nominee, it was really hard to just put someone into there, but I think Techie is worth to mention, just streaming when Kaki's up and all of this, and also try to like really establish himself as a streamer in that way to just put himself beyond, and also a nice and cool community has Techie build up. So Techie is our last nominee on this list.
There you go. Of course, there's a lot more people that we would like to shout out here as well. Of course, there are a lot of other great streamers as well.
Yeah, Giuliano,
and also,
Head
of course, yeah, also a lot of streamers that might have a chance for this category in the next year. Of course, this is for 2023, the entirety of 2023. There's a lot of smaller streamers that, like, for example, Annie started later into 2023. That's why we rather chose streamers that were already a bit more established throughout the entire year. That is, of course, an important thing. We're already in April at this point, so you gotta, bring your brain a little bit backwards to how it looked like in 2023, which these awards are for, of course. But that was a smaller streamer of the year, Birdie, Down, Yave, Tarpor, and Techie. And next one, we already mentioned it before, it is streamer of the year.
Streamer of the year, exactly.
And I'm glad you take that over for me.
Yeah. Because Lars is not nominated, guys. Jokes aside, so again, a smaller streamer is everything under 200 views, so not going into the full-time range of streamers. But guys, our first nominee is someone that you might have heard of. I mean, you're in his Twitch chat. It is Lars TM. So Lars, congratulations. You are... It feels so weird, no? Being nominated.
It is the weirdest thing ever.
Yeah? It feels a bit weird, no?
Literally who?
But I mean, I think after Deep Dip, you kind of really establish yourself as a streamer, because I mean, you tried hard, like changing schedules so often, and now you're there where you belong to. So it's that fair to say that you are one of the streamers of the year.
Definitely.
Definitely. Okay, dude.
You said one of the streamers of the year. I mean, I would definitely say I am one of them. But
okay, nice confidence. Yeah. That's also good. Okay, second one, I think who I also did a lot of stuff with is Maji. Like, Maji's community is so wholesome. I mean, I streamed together with her on Tuesday, it was, and it's just so good to seeing this. Like, the support, the chats, like, the whole vibe in the chat, so nice. And, I mean, Maji really established herself with, also, of course, Maji Monday, but just being very, very committed to Trackmania and showing that as well. I mean, you can see her love and spark to the game. So that's why Maji is also nominated on this category.
Yeah, and also doing just so much for the community, bringing people together, and in general, just such a wholesome community that she has built over the years, and definitely deserving of a spot in Streamer of the Year.
Yeah. Our third nominee, I think we also talked about him extensively during this award show, is none other than our favorite adopted German, Scrappy. Yeah, Scrappy is, when it comes to Cup of the Day, always a safe pick to watch to going into Div 1 or go fast. So he has so many cool challenge ideas also for YouTube. It's so unique and great to seeing this. And also for me, most impressively, was of course the 1000 AT challenge, but also that he tries top 10 on all campaign maps just like 1 week after they released. So dedication, high octane Trackmania gameplay you can see there with a lot of Ayaya and a nice banterish community.
Oh.
Next nominee is Spammy. I mean, probably the backbone of the Trackmania community. Is a no-brainer to put him here. You know, just casting so many events, also joining the World Championship, Spammy of the Day, so many cool ideas as well, getting all the AT medals, playing Cup of the Days also on a regular basis, and I mean, Spam is probably one of the most important, if not the most important streamer of Trackmania, because he filled the gaps that we've had when Trackmania was at its low point. Okay, our penultimate nominee is Wingo Bear, who also really established himself yet again as a French streamer, of course. One of the few ones that we have. I mean, Carl Jr. and also Brent kind of started streaming again. And also Yannix is still there, but we decided to nominee Wingo Bear in this category. Also, like, playing Kaki, being very, very into this game. So that's why we have him in here as well. Yeah, and who's the last nominee? Of course, it's Virtual. I mean, just being our biggest streamer in Trackmania and just pulling numbers. And I think without him, like, a lot of streamers would have been much smaller than they are right now. So we can all just be grateful that Virtual is in this community and, well, just doing what he does, pulling a Virtual.
Yeah, there you go. That were the streamers of the year. Chosen very hard to choose, as we said. There are a lot of streamers who would fit right between smaller and now the streamer of the year. Yeah. Very hard to choose. But these were the six that we came up with. All right, and we're going to the next category. Now it is more about performance and level of play. It is Classic Player of the Year. Three categories left in this award show. And take it off, Marius.
All right, yeah. In the Classic Player of the Year, we focus now on the older games. So outside of Trackmania 2020, we will have five nominees, and they also do play five different environments or games. The first nominee that we have is Dennis090. We saw already in a Cut of the Year a run from him. He got overall 6 Nadio world records in the Trackmania Nations Forever campaign. 5 of them he uploaded to TMX on one single day. And in the information, then when you vote, there is also a video of Virtual going through some of these records.
Yeah. In general, for almost every category you will see in the Google form, we have added all the information. You can just vote by yourselves, but if you want to inform yourselves more, we have put out all the information and how we decided on the nominees and everything like that. You will be able to find it there.
All right, our next nominee comes from Trackmania Torbo. He is kinda here every year, but he deserves this every year again. It is Fanakuri. Like, I always look up, like, how many world records did they get in those campaigns, and I do that with these Trackmania world records channels, thanks also to the guys that host them and always upload the new world record runs. And then I basically just makes string F and type in the name, and then I search how many I get, and I was so surprised about the number. Like, we have 200 maps in Trackmania Turbo, and Fanakuri already had a lot of world records accumulated last year, but just in 2022, but in the previous year he got 64 new world records. Like, what the fuck? Like, insane. With that, he just has to be nominated again and again if he continues that. Like, at some point it must be difficult to improve again, but well, he also got now world records also in different environments. Earlier it was just Canyon and a bit of Valley. Now he definitely got also some more in other environments. Yeah, the next one is Lufok. Yeah, for Trackmania 2 Stadium. Lufok also got multiple Nadio world records, in total 10, if I counted there correctly, in Trackmania 2 Stadium, but he also achieved all 200 STMs in 2023. So achievements in two different games here. Of course, he was also playing Ascension in Team 2020, but we focus here mainly on the achievements in the older games. The next nominee is a Trackmania Canyon player, but also now getting a lot of world records in Valley and partly Lagoon, and that is Meep. He is also kind of standard here because he's so outstandingly good. In the yearly SCL Canyon Team League, he was leading his team Highboys Gold to the victory. In the grand final, he showed again very good performances over all the maps against, of course, the best players and driving also together with some of the best players, but was often top ranking the maps in the final. And he also got a lot of world records, 26 in Trackmania 2 Valley, Canyon and Lagoon combined, and also some world records in Trackmania Turbo. And the last nominee, now from Trackmania United Forever, is Sander. I guess if we had done this voting and this award show in January or December, you might have not known him that well. But now, in April, you know him a lot better already. He is basically the GOAT of Trackmania United Forever. And as we already mentioned earlier, we have the United Masters, which was like the biggest Trackmania United Cup ever, suddenly with prize money and then also a lot. And we had two seasons of that. And he won the first season very dominantly. And in the second season, he was also leading, but then actually left the cup before the grand final. But most likely, if he had played it, he would have won there as well. He won $940. According to eSport earnings, which is now first place, obviously, Trackmania United Forever rankings. Yeah, those are the five nominees for Classic Player of the Year. Dennis, Fanakuri, Lufok, Meep, and Sander.
Yeah, and we're going straight now into the last two categories that we are going to present to you guys today. And they are two very exciting ones, I think. We're starting off now with Most Improved Player of the Year.
All right. Yeah, here we will not focus too much on the results. It is really about players that make a big step and are now in the top level of Trackmania. And our first nominee is actually, and I think he's also in the chat, Ender. Yeah, Ender got a lot stronger in the previous year in several environments. In Team 2020, we realized that as well, but also in Canyon and Valley, like whenever he played a Valley Smurfs Cup, he was dominating it. Whenever in Canyon, he was also improving a lot. In the SCL, he was doing good. In the Gamers Assembly, he got into the final, into fourth place. So huge improvement right there from Ender. The next one that we nominate is Epos. Yeah, we talked about him already earlier a bit, of course, with the Razer Summit LAN, his very strong performance there, very, very dominant. And he also showed dominant performances in a lot of Trackmania World Tour matches. He also got a first place in the British-Irish Cup. The next nominee is Josh. A full speed player that came a bit out of nowhere, but he was in basically many track of the days, he was dominating and getting world records. So he was basically hunting them a lot, but he was also quickly getting to very good times. And he achieved alone in 2023, 16 track of the day world records while only focusing on full speed style. He also won the Split Masters monthly competition, had a bit of prize money as well, which was probably also the full speed edition of the cup. And he also won one full speed of the week. He didn't play that many, I guess. All right, our next nominee is Pushtito Paco. Yeah, Paco became also one of the very top drivers in the previous year and also delivered in the World Tour. Remarkable was his live world record on the map Twisted.
Yeah.
The World Tour matches.
That was great.
The next one is Soliver Ganz. Yeah, you know him very well now with the campaign hunting, but already last year, from the four campaigns that existed, he skipped, I think, the boring spring one, But from the 4 campaigns, in 3 of them, he ended up in the top 2. He was twice 2nd in the campaign ranking. And then finally, in fall 2023, he got a 1st place in a very, very close fight with Mother. That fight actually went a bit into 2024, so it might also play a role in next year's award show. The next player is Stufz. Yeah, he also showed some very dominant and great performances during the Trackmania World Tour, but also in various other big competitions. He was in the top positions. And also he had a very remarkable run on the map Vortex, where he got the online live match world record. And yeah, some other results, 2nd place in the Comic-Con Baltics behind Elcon, and also in the Razor Summit, and also in the Gamax. And our last nominee, the 7th one, is 12th. Yeah, actually, sadly, he doesn't play other competitions. We only know him from the Cup of the Day. But starting with 2023, I think that's so very difficult to figure out, but I think he was around 8 Cup of the Day wins at that time, I would think. But now he is in the top 5 in the whole ranking, almost at 40 wins. So this is how much he won since then. And he also had a back-to-back Cup of the Day victory that was also part of it. Scrappy's 5-win streak actually had a 2nd place before the 5-win streak started. That 2nd place was against 12, otherwise Scrappy would have won 6 times. So 12 really improved heavily. And you see that in Cup of the Day, and there are the best, some of the best players as well, so heavily deserved. Yep. So yeah, these are our 7 nominees for most improved player of the year.
I think I think a very difficult category to choose as well.
But I think Yakosto just puts it in well. I think it's very complete. We try to consider everything in there. And yeah, I mean, Marius, you did an insane job there. We discussed about it, but you gave arguments, like, insane job. And I think...
Very passionate about this. Yeah. And I think you can see it in these awards, definitely, that we were very passionate and want to showcase everybody. And in general, this is kind of a celebration of Trackmania in the year 2023. And we wanted to give back to you guys, of course, as well, with hosting this to the community, because you guys deserve it.
Yeah.
And but with all, with all of that said, we come now to the final category of the awards, Trackmania Awards 2023. You've been waiting for it. It is Player of the Year. And I think in previous years, this was sometimes a very easy category to vote for, because often like one player really stuck out. I think this time, this one is going to be very exciting. And of course, the first one, we have to start with him. You all know already. It is Carl Jr. First one for Player of the Year. Of course, he won World Tour or Grand League Stage 1 together with his teammate Pack. They also got a 2nd place in the World Championship. And in Ascension, in the most important match that we've had in Trackmania history, pretty much, the biggest prize pool, he had the most points at the end. Did sadly not get through in a finalist mode where Gren won, but he had the most points. Points-wise, he was the best or most consistent player in Ascension. Very impressive stuff. Next one we have is Elcon, actually. Elcon has gotten the 5th most prize money throughout 2023, even though he did not play Ascension or also was not as successful in TMGL. Of course, with Elcon, he had not the best run in TMGL in 2023. But if you take that aside, he had an amazing year. He got a 1st and 2nd place in Magi Monday, which is just a huge amount of prize money right there. Got 1st place in Comic-Con Baltics, BDS Pringles Cup, also winning 1,000 euro there. So much stuff, so many competitions especially that he played. And we felt like he was definitely deserved to be mentioned here. Next one, our fellow German. It is Granadi, of course, from Berlin International Gaming. He got a third place in Ascension, won his qualifier, got second place in XP Evo. Incredible stuff all throughout the entire year. Of course, great memes and everything as well, but also just incredible performances. He is so consistent, so fast, and he really shined throughout the last year. Then, next one, also pretty much a given. It is a Gwen who won Ascension this year. Biggest prize pool in the history of Trackmania that we have ever seen. He also got a first place in the Cupra Cup with a lot of prize pool as well. And also managed to get a third place with his teammate in the World Tour Stage 1 as well in the playoffs. Great stuff there by Gwen throughout 2023, winning when it was most important. Next is Mother. Really shined through 2023 as well. Managed to get a first place with his teammate Soldier in the World Tour Stage 2. Winning TMGL Stage 2. Really, really great stuff. They were so fast on all the maps. Also got a third and fourth place in the World Championship once again for Alliance. He got all world records on all Vampus maps just while playing at the highest level at TMGL. Also just managed to get that on the side. Also got second place in the fall campaign, as we mentioned earlier, where he had a great fight against Silver Guns. Just incredible whatever he touched or tried in the game, he performed at the highest level. Next one, another one who had a breakthrough year in 2023, it is Otak. Otak, of course, obviously won with Brent together in the World Championships. They took first place and become World Champions. But not only that, Otak also won XP Evo as well by himself. Great effort there as well. And also got a second place in the Afraid Cup that we also saw previously. And last but not least, we also have Scrappy, a four player of the year, the last nominee. He got third place in Magic Mondays. He got the RMC and RMS world records in 2023, one of the most 104 world records. He got more than 100 cover day wins, including 5 cover day wins in a row. And with that, with those performances, definitely up there. Not really in the esports scene for Scrappy, but in terms of other achievements, he was definitely up there at anything that he played. And that is the last category done. Player of the year. That is one of the hardest ones. Yeah.
Guys, you know when we predicted how long this will take?
I was like, an hour, 3 hours, right?
And you guys were like 1 to 1.5 hours. Yeah,
maybe
surely.
2. But yeah, here we have the last quiz. Yeah. Carl Jr., Alcon, Granadi, Gwen, Mother, Otak, and Scrappy. Well, yeah. There you go. That was the last category. And with that, we're through with the awards. Thank you guys for watching, and now you have the chance to vote. We will be giving you guys the voting or the Google form very soon. I would like to post it right now, but I had it in my clipboard to copy paste it immediately, but I had to copy paste giant block of Margie earlier, so wait a second, let me quickly get the link. That was more important, clearly. Here we go. All right, that is the link right there in chat. You can find it right there. That is the link. It is also pinned right now as well in my Discord. I also am gonna do a quick announcement as well. There you go. I will also showcase the Google form quickly on Dings as well. On the on the stream. All right, so here we go. Here you can see. So this is a Google form, a little bit bright, of course, now, but here you can find the information. First of all, the Trackmania Awards 2023 are finally here. Here we will find all the different categories and nominees that we chose. The deadline is in 1 week, 21st of April, Sunday. You have until 23:59. If you're unsure, you can watch, of course, the stream that we just did, or check the more info pages that we have placed here. None of the questions are required. You can fill out as many as you want, or you can leave them also blank. That is no problem. And also the final results will then be presented also on this channel once again on the 27th of April. So here we go. First section is events, offline event, online event of the year. We have creative project of the year. Then going next, we have map of the year. Here you can see all the maps again. If you wanna take a more detailed look as well, you can also click on more info here. For example, we have provided all of these where you can then see, for example, for Trackmania Exchange, yeah, you can find the map link here, for example, to get more information for all of these right here. Basically, you find all the video links and everything for movies, videos of the year as well, tasks of the year. You find everything here. You can go through on your own, take your time. You have 1 week to send in all of the all of the votes. Also here, for example, with Match of the Year, you can see we have quite a bit of information if you're unsure about some things that you can look at once again. Of course, one last time, this is supposed to be an unbiased Trackmania Awards. I would like you to try to answer as truthfully as you can, obviously. Make this a great award show that we might even do again.
Yeah, I hope so.
Yeah, it was really fun. You have, as I said, 1 week, and hope we will get a lot of answers on this one. I am definitely looking forward to what you guys will be voting. These are, by the way, you have one, that's why you have the email here. You have one single vote in this Google form. However, you are allowed to edit your votes. You can edit them later if you submit them already. You can edit them, no problem. It's just one vote per person, of course. Yeah, here you go. These are the last categories. You can go through them at your own pace and decide who will win. And we will find out on the 27th, in 2 weeks' time, and I am certainly looking forward to that.
Yeah, it would be a lot of fun.
Oh, in this way. I'm sorry, Turbo.
I think now you can hear me again.
Hello? Yeah, in that scene, I didn't have the Discord scene. Whoops.
Yeah, so I was talking. I just said that Lars, you should not vote for Lars.
Yes.
No, jokes aside. So you have time up until next week. So the 21st at 23:59. And then on the 27th of April, 2024 at 20 CEST, there will be the award. Yeah, like just who won. So,
yeah.
In 2 weeks on the Saturday.
So in 13 days.
Yeah, I want to give a big shout out once again to Turbo and Marius also here on the stream. We have all worked together a lot, and this would have never been possible if we hadn't worked together to get all of this stuff going. So big shout out to them. They are in the title of the stream as well. You can follow them probably also in the description. If I upload this to YouTube, you will be able to find all their information as well. So definitely huge shout out to them. Also, one thing for Mapper of the Year, Agrabu helped us a lot, and the Waypoint team to be able to come down to our nominees there. I hope you enjoyed the show, and we will hopefully then see you guys in 2 weeks' time once again for the results. In the meantime, have fun voting on the categories. I hope you enjoyed, and See you then.